or something for lead pages? Like, that's really, I wonder if it's a hook thing or what. That's interesting. Anyway.
All right, we're live.
What's up, folks? Good to see everybody. I'm Brian. Y'all know who I am. I got my friend Mariah down here in the avatar thing down there.
Down here in the little box.
So say hello to her. So Mariah, I met Mariah last, well, we've never met in person, actually. We need to do that one day, Mariah. But Mariah emailed me last January. She was just starting I can't say the name of your website, so we're going to have a naming conversation somewhere during this.
I can't even barely spell it.
Like, at least once a week, I refer your site to somebody and I'm like, I don't know how to spell it. Just Google Mariah Coz and you'll find it. And something about femme at the beginning. But Mariah is really awesome. She has been on my case to do webinars for the past year, probably harder than anybody else. And finally, last November, I did my first webinar. And it's kind of strange. Like, we build up these things in our head that we're like opposed to for some weird unknown reason. Like right now, I'm writing a blog post that'll come out tomorrow, the first part of it. So keep your eyes out for that, about doing affiliate launches of your course or whatever program you have. And for a long time, I had this negative connotation of doing affiliate type of stuff because some people I saw that were doing that, I didn't like the way they were doing it. And I was like, I just kind of want to stay away from that completely. In reality, the strategy is great. You just have to do them in the right way. So anyways, I've had all these like weird ideas in my head about webinars. And finally, last November, I was like, you know what? This is stupid that I'm doing this just because I don't like how somebody else is doing it. I need to just do the thing. And it absolutely killed. And Mariah gave me several tips and tricks we're going to talk about through the course of this workshop. We're going to teach you. Mariah has a really cool presentation. And I'm really hyperbole at all. I'm really, really interested to watch this webinar. She sent me a recording of it. She's done this a few times for some other folks. She sent me a recording of it that I skimmed through and some slides to look through so I could prep and write the emails to invite you guys and all. And we've had a lot of conversations just privately on Skype about this. But I'm really interested because one of the most interesting parts of what she's going to teach today is this is a strategy you can use at the very beginning. And those strategies are actually really hard to find. Like, I've been teaching list building for about a year solid now. I've been trying to build my email list for over 2 years, and trying to find strategies that people can use on day one is actually not easy to find. A lot of the stuff you see out there is optimization techniques and that kind of stuff. So Mariah's going to talk to us today about webinars and how to use them in the very beginning, how to use them to build a list, even if you don't have one, and then how to sell a product, even if you perhaps don't even know what the product's going to be yet, or you don't have the product built yet on your first webinar. So I'm really excited about this. Mariah is one of the smartest marketers I know. Follow her, subscribe to her list now, go follow her stuff. She's really cool. So without further ado, Mariah, come school me, come school the audience, teach us how to do what you do.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Brian. That is super nice of you. And thank you for that really nice intro. Like you said, we met last year when I was just starting this, my most recent business. I've actually been in online business for the last 7 years, which not everyone realizes, but this is not my first rodeo.
Which makes me feel better. Like,
I think a lot of people,
things in a year.
A lot of people, I think like, you know, it's interesting because Femtrepreneur as a business started from absolute zero last year in January, no followers, no email list, and, you know, has obviously grown so exponentially and so quickly itself. But that's because, like, I built other businesses before that. I had like a online clothing store. I had a design business, like an actual like architecture design business, had other courses and other businesses in the past. So kind of getting to the point where I was like, okay, I feel like I can do this the right way now and kind of do it without I think the fear of, just like you said, like everyone kind of comes out with that fear of like, well, I can't do webinars, or I can't approach other people to work with me, or, you know, I'm not big enough. I'm not established enough. And just kind of being like, that stuff doesn't matter. You have a lot of other value to bring. That's a lot of what we're going to be talking about today too. So I have a very detailed presentation for you guys. I talk really fast and I give away a lot of little details that you're going to want to remember. This is not like a broad, vague overview that's like, oh, cool, like I wrote down the 5 steps and that was it. This is going to be like, you're literally going to be able to walk away today and do your first webinar if you want to. And I'm going to hope that you do. I'm going to convince you by the end that you should. But just so you know, a lot of people come to this training and just from the free training that we're doing today, walk away and are able to bring in from anywhere from $800 to, you know, $3,000 in a couple days after by doing their first webinar. So that is my hope for you. I'm going to switch over to screen sharing mode. And you guys, when you're here, just feel free to type in your questions as they come up for you in the chat. You guys have the pleasure of hanging out with my team, Megan Minns and Beverly Bean, the two most adorable people in the world that I'm lucky enough to be able to work with. And so they are going to be hanging out in the chat with you. And you can just... you can ask your questions and they're going to keep track of everything and we're going to get to all your questions at the end. All right, I'm going to screen share with you guys and we will dive in. Please get your notebooks out.
I'm going to turn my ugly face off too so you don't have to look at my face all the time, but I'll be right here hanging out.
All right, awesome. Cool. Yeah, and I'm excited to hear too at the end more about, you know, more about how Bryan's been using webinars. I think a lot of you guys can probably relate to having some resistance to doing them, which is fine. But I'm going to show you how to not feel nervous about that and really, really just get excited and fall in love with webinars the way that I have. All right. So before we start, I want you guys to turn off everything in the background that could distract you, like email or Skype or anything else that's going on. You're here to learn, right? I want you to silence your phone and get ready to learn these exact strategies. Like I said, this is very detailed, no fluff, actionable stuff. So I want you guys to get every little detail. These are some of the notes that people sent me pictures of the last time I did this presentation. So there is a lot to learn and I want you guys to get your pen and paper out. There's a lot of diagrams, there's a lot of images, a lot of things you're gonna wanna take note of. So if you guys wanna hang out with us after, my place to hang out is Twitter, and if you guys want to use the hashtag webinar launch and ask me questions after the webinar or just, you know, kind of get in touch, hang out with each other after the webinar, you can use the hashtag webinar launch. And I want you guys to stay tuned to the very end because I'm going to show you how to get your very own fill-in-the-blank, done-for-you signature webinar slides template so that you can get started with your webinars really quickly. Okay, so I know I introduced myself a little bit already, but my name is Mariah. I started doing webinars last March, so March 2015. I made $4,000 in 1 hour on my first ever webinar. Now, I had no pitch, no structure. I didn't have a slide presentation. I didn't know what I was doing. I was just talking kind of really unstructuredly and pretty badly, but I still made $4,000 in that hour, and I started freaking out. I was like, holy crap, look at the potential here, right? I started obsessing over webinars. I've done more than 65 webinars. That's even more now. That's like 75 or 80 webinars now since then. Mostly I do joint venture webinars with my secret sauce. And we're going to talk about what that looks like and what that means. I've been able to grow my list. Again, this is outdated as of like a week ago because I did two webinars this week. So now I have 16,000 people on my list instead of 13. Went from making $10,000 a month with my business and courses to more than $100,000 a month because of using webinars. That's what's allowed me to scale my business. So I now have some of the highest conversion rates in the industry. I'm going to show you why that happens. And for me, because I used to be in a punk band, I'm the lead singer and lead guitarist in my band. To me, it's the closest thing to performing live on stage that I can do in my business, right? So if I'd rather be like with a guitar singing and dancing on stage, this to me is kind of the same thing. This to me is the same kind of excitement that I get from something like that.
I'm going to need to see some pictures of that, Mariah.
No, the pictures are very inappropriate. I don't really
even
wear
better.
Clothes.
Like that, you got to put them in here now.
No, I don't. There's not a lot of clothing going on in those shows. created, and I can't tell you what my band is called because it's very inappropriate. So I created Webinar Rockstar, and I've helped more than 800 people have 4- and 5-figure webinars within 7 days of starting. I'm all about just making this a very quick and easy process. Look, guys, getting started with webinars is not, I think it's like Bryan said, it's rare to find a strategy that's so impactful and yet so easy to get started with. That's not like, oh yeah, I'm gonna work towards that for 3 months or 6 months. It's like, no, in 7 days, you should be able to pull this off and I'm gonna show you how, okay? So our point today is to show you how to have your first profitable webinar in 7 days. That's what I'm gonna show you today. So I'm looking at you guys in the chat. I'm looking at all of your questions and comments, and I have a question for you. Have you ever done a webinar before? So who here has done a webinar before? I almost just whistled a little bit. If you haven't done a webinar before, why not? So what are some of the things that are holding you back or scaring you or, you know, kind of making you feel unsure about this? I know that for me, it was the tech stuff. You know, before I'd ever done a webinar, the tech stuff was scary. So I want to know if you have done a webinar, how did it go? Are you happy with your results? If you haven't done a webinar, why not, right? What's going on? I see some people saying that they have, a lot of people saying no, they've never done a webinar before. Yes, we've done a handful. Let's see, will anybody, afraid that no one will come, afraid that you don't feel like an expert, don't have any list. Okay, yeah, we're gonna talk about how to use webinars to build your email list. That's exactly, if you looked at my email list, it would just be a patchwork of other people's email lists, and it's all from doing webinars, okay? Ooh, did one this morning. Well, welcome.
Proactive.
Yeah, you have a busy day. You hate being on camera. That's okay. You don't have to be on camera yourself if you don't want to be. Let's see. Okay, awesome. So a lot of people feel like they don't have an email list yet to get started. That's actually exactly where I was when I started. And I was like, how the heck am I going to get an email list? I know, I'll do some webinars. So webinars are awesome. I'm going to tell you guys about why webinars are so awesome. But they're the best way to launch your course or service, whatever you guys, you know, I'm also interested if you guys type in the chat, how many of you here sell a course or want to sell a product like Bryan and I do? How many of you guys sell services? It works for both, but I am curious kind of what the split is here in today's audience. So it's the best way to make sales and then create recurring revenue from your evergreen course, okay? This is the only way I found to make consistent revenue in my business in between launches, okay? So webinars are awesome because you're gonna be able to grow your email list big time and quickly. We're talking about numbers like getting 600 new email subscribers in 48 hours. Like before I knew how to do webinars, 600 new email subscribers would take me like 2 months, okay? Because it would be a very slow process. Now it's like, in a day, I can get 1,000 email subscribers. Let's see, I see a lot of courses, services. Interesting, I kind of feel like services is kind of like winning out. Do you feel like that, Bryan?
That's actually interesting to see, yeah.
Yeah, I thought it'd be a lot, all courses, but all right, so second reason, you guys can sell like a boss on a webinar, okay? And the conversion rates are incredible. We're talking up to 40%. This is unheard of in any other medium. And you guys, Bryan talks about this, you probably know this. Email is gonna convert at anywhere from like 1 to 3% if you're lucky. My emails convert higher, but even then, like my best email launch sequence would convert at 10%. Like that was the best I could do. And then with social media, we're talking like 0.01% or something terrible. Yeah, not even anything. But on webinars, you can convert up to 40% of people into buyers. Now that is crazy. That is just unheard of in any other medium. That means that if you have only 10 people on your webinar, which is not hard to do, right? Let's say you just have 10 people on your list coming to your webinar, 5 of them could buy or 4 of them could buy. And if that's a $1,000 product that you're selling, like your premium course or premium coaching package, that's $4,000. I mean, it's the best way to make money with a really small audience. It also allows you to build real, meaningful relationships with other people in your industry, right? So a lot of times people say, you got to be building.
You know,
finding your business friends, and then they don't tell you how, right? Or it's just like, how are you going to actually build a meaningful relationship with someone who you just meet on the internet? The way I've been able to do that is all through webinars, because it's like this short, fun little project. It takes a couple days to set up. You guys work on a project together for a couple days, and then you become friends after. That's how I built all my relationships online. You can also build your authority, okay? So when you start doing webinars, this is gonna happen whether you like it or not. You're gonna become the go-to person in your niche. So someone said, I feel like I don't have the expertise. Guess what? Expertise isn't like sprinkled on you by a fairy. It's something that you have to go out and say, hi, I'm gonna come and talk about this topic that I kind of know about, I'm passionate about, I have a bit of experience about. And then authority happens when you do that, Okay. So that expert status happens when you just talk about the thing that you are passionate about, basically. That's how it happens. It's not some kind of magical thing where, you know, a number rolls over and then you have that expertise, right? You're also going to grow your brand and stand out. And this was a really big thing for me. I started becoming recognized for these signature webinars that I was doing. People started saying, oh my gosh, yeah, that's Mariah. She does these really fun webinars, or she does these really detailed webinars that are really helpful and actually valuable and not just, you know, a sales pitch, right? So it's actually going to help you stand out in a really saturated and crowded market when everyone else is blogging and going on Instagram and whatever they're doing. You're taking it one step further and doing a webinar. That right there is going to just set you apart from everyone else in your industry. And the engagement with your audience is amazing, okay? So what you guys are seeing in the live chat right now and the Q&A at the end of this webinar, this has been so, so good for my business, where I just get to actually talk to you guys and like answer your actual questions. I'm not just guessing what your questions might be. You know, when I can look at the chat and say, oh, here's Claire, you know, Claire just asked a question and I can address Claire by her name and connect with her in that way. You can't do that in other mediums, right? It's not the same. Twitter is not the same. Instagram is not the same. You can't do this in other mediums. Okay, guys, it's different to hear someone calling out your question and really engaging you in that way. It also means that you're creating content that you can use again and again. So every time I do a webinar, that's something that I could publish to YouTube. That's something I could sell the recordings of. I could make funnels out of it. I could make a free opt-in out of it and grow my email list that way. There's so many ways to repurpose your webinars once you've done them. It's pretty amazing. Look, webinars are super scalable, guys. If you can get 100 people to show up, if you can get even 10 people to show up, right? You can get 1,000 people to show up. That's just a matter of time. Scaling without more work, that's the name of the game. Okay, guys, this is one of those things that I found that I don't know how to do this in any other way. And webinars are what have allowed me to scale my business so quickly within a year. They're also the perfect, perfect medium for small audiences. I said this before and I'm going to say it again. No matter how small your turnout is during that day of your webinar, you can have a profitable webinar strategy as long as you have the right things going on, right? As long as you have that strategy, you're still going to be able to make money on your webinars, even if you only have 20 people in your audience, okay? So it's one of those things that people say, oh my gosh, how am I going to make sales for my email list? There's only 100 people. Do a webinar. That's going to be the best way. All right, so I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about my experience with webinars, and then I'm going to show you some case studies, and then we're going to get into the step-by-step breakdown of how to actually perform your webinar, and then we're going to talk about the technology. Oh my gosh, we have so much coming up.
I love the thinking picture with your hand.
Look at me, I'm thinking.
I need one of those. I'm going to go.
Using my brain. okay, so in March of 2015, I did my first webinar with less than 24 hours notice. Now, this is really important. I had been talking and thinking about doing webinars for 6 months before I actually did one. Now, that makes me cringe now. It makes me so mad that I didn't just take the leap, but I was so anxious. Guys, like I said, I'm in a band. You know, I perform live, but going live on camera, I mean, I was like seriously terrified, and the tech stuff was just like, I couldn't wrap my head. I just am not a technical person at all. So what I knew I had to do was basically announce to my very, very small audience at the time of just like 200 people and be like, I'm going to do this webinar. Sign up here to get notified about it. And I was like, oh crap. Like, I definitely need to, I was basically like, I definitely am going to need to figure this out now, because I told everyone that I was going to do it. So I figure out everything within that 24 hours. It's kind of crazy, but it ends up being successful. Okay, so the lesson here is that you need to force yourself to commit with a deadline. Okay, you need to tell your audience, if you're like, oh my gosh, I'm never gonna get this done, I'm so nervous. If you're not giving yourself the time to figure it out, announce it and then be like, I'll figure it out, okay? Right, I'll figure it out in between, you know, you don't have to give yourself 24 hours, but I do think it's important to give yourself like a couple days and just force yourself to do it.
Basically. And be self-aware enough to know, like, if you've never spoken in front of people ever at all, it's probably going to take you slightly longer than somebody that's maybe been in front of people a little bit. So like, but that time constraint is huge. Like yesterday afternoon, There was a webinar. It's kind of a workshop, but similar to a webinar, just with no pitch on the end. And I put together the slide deck and the entire presentation in an hour and a half.
Yeah.
And it would have taken me 4 days had that just been a task I needed to do this week. It would have taken me forever, but the time constraint itself made me actually do it super quick. So there's a lot to that, but be self-aware. Know that, hey, if this is my first time to ever speak to more than three people, like there's probably going to be some mental barriers that you're going to have to overcome, and budget some time for that.
Yeah. And I think, yeah, like if you gave yourself, what I tell people is give yourself a week, but announce it and give yourself a week to figure it out. And that is plenty of time. Like I always tell people, if I could do it in 24 hours with no clue what was going on, you can do it in a week, right? So no matter where you're at, I do think that's true. And I do think there's an element of just like brute forcing yourself to try something new, right? Absolutely. It's like just take, like jumping off, you know, bungee jumping or something. Like you just have to try it. And then once you do it, you know, if you hate it, you never have to do it again. But most likely you're going to find how exhilarating it is, and you're going to make money, and you're going to be like, holy crap, like I feel so empowered that I just made $2,000 in an hour, right? Which it used to take me 2 weeks to make that much, or 3 weeks to make that much. And I think once you do it, you're going to be like, holy crap, the potential is huge, right? So I promoted this first webinar for just 24 hours. I figured out all the tech stuff by trial and error. Like I said, there was no guide when I started. Like I could not find a tutorial or anything. I just had to literally try a bunch of things and be like, oh crap, that worked. Okay. And then I was surprised to see that 300 people registered. Okay. And I'm going to tell you how I promoted that. But basically, what happened was that I was totally hooked. Right. So I saw that I had 300 new email subscribers in 24 hours. That did never, ever happen to me before. I thought that was crazy. We made $4,000 in 1 hour without a presentation or a pitch. Guys, I did not have slide decks back then. I didn't even have slide decks until like a month ago, to be honest. I would just get on a webinar and start kind of talking about the area that I was interested in. I did not have a pitch. I just told people at the end that I was going to be coming out with a new course in a month, and that they could buy it if they wanted to. And I saw the potential of webinars right there and then, right? It's like I couldn't replicate that with anything else. And then after that first day, I started doing them twice a week. I started experimenting with all different types of bundles, which we're going to talk about, all different types of offers. And I started doing joint venture webinars to different audiences. Okay. So I was really experimenting with like, if I do it to this audience of bloggers, how is it different than doing it to an audience of, you know, health coaches? And I was just basically doing as many webinars as I physically could to just figure out the best strategies. Okay. So I was learning everything sort of by trial and error and doing it myself. So what happened next after I started doing webinars every week or sometimes twice a week? What happened? It's pretty clear when you look at the actual stats that everything changed. Okay. So this to me, when I looked at this and I put all of my sort of metrics on top of each other and I was like, holy crap, like you can't argue with that. Right. So within 30 days, all of my major metrics tripled. Okay. So my email list, my blog traffic, and my revenue skyrocketed. Okay. You can literally see the turning point in the data, right? Like you can see, okay, Mariah does her first webinar and then the traffic shoots up. Okay. Didn't do my first webinar. And then look at my email list before doing webinars and after doing webinars, right? Revenue. This is when we had our first, I think we had our first $50,000 month. And then 2 months later, we had our first $100,000 month from doing webinars. So like I said, guys, you just can't argue with this. This to me is like the hockey stick, you know, that people talk about. And I never thought that would happen for me. And it was, you know, look at the struggle of like my traffic was like dipping. No matter what I did, my traffic was going down, down, down. And then I started doing webinars and it went back up again. So this to me was an actual turning point that I can look at in the data and say, that's the thing that changed everything. I really want to talk about how webinars will simplify your to-do list. So how many people here in the chat, tell me how many people here feel like they have too much to do in their business? How many people feel like, oh my gosh, I mean, guys, I felt like this when I found Bryan's blog and I was like, okay, great. Now I have 100 new strategies I have to try. Thanks, Bryan. But seriously, I mean, there's so much good stuff on Bryan's blog. We all know that. And there's so many little strategies and things to try. But I felt like I had so much to do in your business. Like who feels like, oh my gosh, holy crap. Like, I have to write blog posts. I have to make content upgrades. I have to make eBooks. I have to do ads. I have to do grow my email list. I have to grow my engagement with my followers. I have to give free value. I have to make money. You know, what about that? Like, it's just overwhelming, right? Someone is saying, I am so overwhelmed. There's so much to do. They have five projects going on at any given time and everything feels like a priority, right? Like, growing your email list is just as important as making money. And so is taking care of your customers. And so, you know what I mean? There's just, they're all priorities. But webinars have helped me simplify my business in this really intentional way that makes us way, way more money, but also is a lot easier on us, okay? So right now you're like, okay, I gotta make money. I gotta launch, right? I have to find new affiliates and I have to set up joint ventures, whatever the heck those are, right? You're thinking, I gotta do promotions, I gotta do sales, I gotta do special price increases, I gotta make money, right? I gotta sell new products. I gotta come out with something new to sell people that I already have, right? And then you're thinking, okay, on my other list, I got to do list building. So that means I got to make content upgrades. I have to do a giveaway. I have to start guest posting. I have to outreach to all of those bloggers that I want to guest post on and on and on, right? And then you're like, oh yeah, I have to make content. So I have to write a blog post every week. I have to make a YouTube video. Someone's telling me to make a guide and write an ebook and put that up for free. And on top of all that free content, I somehow have to also make products that I can sell, right? These are all separate activities that before I started doing webinars were taking up all of my time, energy, and money, okay? List building, making sales, relationship building, which is like a whole other world on its own, and then creating content. But now with webinars, they're all happening at the same time, okay? So every single time I do my webinars, I build my email list, I make sales, I build relationships, not only with the other person that I'm co-hosting with, but also with you guys, okay? So I'm building two sets of relationships. Like, let's talk about killing 10 birds with one stone, right? And then I'm also creating content that I can use again and again, that I can post on my blog, I can put on my YouTube channel, I can, you know, maybe I'll cut off, you know, I'll cut this down into 10 5-minute videos and do a series on YouTube or just put a little bit of it up there. I'm creating all this content as well. That's what webinars allow you to do. If you can only do one thing, guys, if you have kids, if you have a 9-to-5 job and you are a side hustler, if you have 5 businesses like I have, if you can only do one thing, it needs to be webinars, okay? If you are strapped for time or resources, you need to just literally cross everything else off your list right now. I give you permission to do that and just be like, I'm gonna do my first webinar. That's all I need to do. And I'm going to make money, build my email list, create content, and build relationships all in an hour. Okay? Guys, I made you a Venn diagram. That's how passionate I am about this.
definitely hit geek status once you make a Venn diagram.
Exactly. I mapped this out for myself because I felt like it was so, so important for me and for my students and for my team to understand why all that we were going to do is webinars. That's all we do, okay? And looking at how it just brings everything together in the intersection of list building, making money, and creating content is webinars, okay? So in that 1 hour that you're doing your live webinar, you're doing more than I could do in like a month,
hey,
right?
Hey, my question. Yeah. Effectiveness as a teaching tool. So most of those things are around the benefit to the entrepreneur side, the benefit to the student watching it side. You've had some pretty interesting stats of the effectiveness of your webinar as far as the student getting the result. Can you talk about that for just a second?
Oh my gosh, so much better. So here's the thing, guys. It's really easy, I think, to ignore a blog post. A lot of people like coming to my blog, but you know, they might just save something or tweet it or repin it and be like, oh, I'll look at that later. When people come to my webinars, not only are they learning the actual information in a much more visual way, right? These webinars, I can actually show you things. A lot of times I'll switch over and actually do a demo. If I'm talking about how to use lead pages, I'll show you how to do that on a webinar. If I'm talking about using Squarespace, I'll show you how I use Squarespace on the webinar. It's a lot more actionable. People leave my webinars, and because I'm so, the way I do webinars is that I really want to give you like one specific thing that you can go and do like in an hour or two, right? I don't want you to just get this broad overview of like a 6-month plan. I want you to just have one thing you can go and do. And so people leave, and then the next day they email me or they tweet at me and they're like, okay, I made my landing page. Like, what do I do now? Or, okay, I set up my webinar. I just did my first webinar. You know, 3 days from now, I'll get an email from some of you telling me that you did your first webinar and that you made $4,000 or that you made $800 or whatever. So to me, this is just a lot more effective at getting my information across. I'm a much better like verbal teacher and visual teacher. I love writing, but I know that it doesn't get the point across quite as well as seeing this Venn diagram, right? Does that make sense? Does that kind of answer your question?
Yeah. And I think the, like you had a stat saying you had helped 800 students do 4 or 5 figure launches just from your free training. Like that's mind blowing. I absolutely.
Oh yeah. No, that's from Webinar Rockstar too.
Yeah. That's great. I love it. So yeah. I think it's interesting just for, and this is something I've been trying to realign myself, and I think you do a great job of this, is there's kind of two sides of it. There's the help yourself side and there's help the student side, and making sure we always cover both of those sides. And that's one of the things I really love about webinars is your show up live numbers. The people that are actually on the webinar are probably going to be lower than who actually reads a blog post, but the effectiveness person per person is infinitely higher on a webinar than reading a blog post, because a blog post, you get one distraction, you're gone. When you're watching this live, it's a whole lot harder to pull away from it than when you're reading a blog post or pretty much any other medium. So I think the effectiveness of them on the student side is exponentially higher.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like the minute you do your first webinar, you're just instantly providing more value than anyone else, you know, who's just a blogger or just providing text content or even like, I don't know. I feel like it's just the best. I'm providing more value, and I get this, you know, in emails and in tweets from my audience, just feeling like I'm delivering more value than anyone else in my extremely saturated niche, because I'm doing constant webinars, which are like essentially course trainings, right? Like people feel like they're getting what they should be paying for, right? People are like, oh my gosh, I feel like I should have paid for that. I'm embarrassed. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, I just want, and I want people to feel like that. I want people to feel like that should have cost money, but it didn't. Okay, so let's look at the results. Let's look at what happens when you cut out everything else and you cross everything else off your to-do list and you just start focusing on webinars, right? We all know how important it is to focus in our business in order to get results. And this is what's going to happen. So I started adding thousands of people to my email list every month instead of hundreds, right? This is actually an old screenshot because I don't use MailChimp anymore, but the ConvertKit graphs are not as pretty because they're much more like jagged. I don't know if you guys noticed that. I also have been able to do tons of collaborations and create affiliate relationships and just like friends. Before I started this business, I had no business friends. I had no one I could talk to when I had a problem or an issue or was feeling upset about something. Now I have tons of business friends that I can talk to when I need advice or I need help. And it's all because of doing webinars. Okay, so every single one of these people you see here, I met them because we did a webinar together and now we're super close friends. And it was just a way of kind of getting that kind of in with someone and then being able to build and grow that relationship from there. Okay. And a lot of those people end up promoting me down the line, which is awesome. My revenue tripled, then quadrupled, then 10x'd by doing webinars. Now, I'm not saying that's going to happen for you. I'm not saying that you should be doing a webinar every single week. I know that that's a lot, but if it's the one thing that you're doing, it's totally doable. Okay. If you stop doing all the little bullshit that's like not helping you, or all the little things that just aren't adding up to something that's a really big ROI, webinars can do that for you. Okay. It's also the only way that I've been able to make recurring evergreen sales, even in between big launches. So you can see here, this is an actual screenshot. So every single weekend or every week, these big spikes are the days we do the webinars. But then in between, you can see that we're still making daily sales as well. So altogether, this means that we're, you know, bringing in evergreen revenue every single day, which is really nice as a business owner. I used to live in the feast and famine cycle, and that sucked, right? And again, this is kind of a diagram of like what this looks like on my calendar, right? So you make the small daily sales of, you know, little products. And then on the webinars every week, we have a chunk of money coming in, which is awesome. And then every couple of months, we're going to do an actual launch. It's also allowed me to kind of do what I call network hacking, and this is through the joint venture webinars. But basically what's happened to me over the last few months is I started out doing a webinar with one person, that person would introduce me to one other person, and then that person would introduce me to two other people, and then, you know, some of those people would tell their friends about me, and it just ended up spreading out to the point where tons of people that, you know, 6 degrees of separation, but people started reaching back out to me and being like, I want to do a webinar with you. People that I would be like, oh my God, like, how do you even know who I am? Like, I'm such a big fan. I'm an admirer. You know, people that I used to just look up to and admire in business now started coming to me and saying, hey, why haven't you invited me to do a joint venture webinar? I want to do one too. So it basically just kind of spread out from there, and people will start telling their colleagues and friends about you. It doesn't happen overnight, right? It happened over 8 months, but that's still relatively quickly. Okay, and then so since then we've done more than, actually, again, this is outdated, but done more than $1 million in course sales in 10 months and 16,000 new email subscribers, all from webinars. Okay, that's the ultimate result of what we've been able to do in the last year by really focusing on this stuff. Okay, again, the ConvertKit graphs aren't as pretty because they're too spiky. So let's look at some case studies of some real people making real money with webinars. Okay. We're just gonna run through these. We're gonna look at four different people who did their webinars. So first one is my friend Jenna Sword. She did a course and a course bundle. Now you're gonna see different types of bundles where I talk about people putting two courses together, or a course and a bonus, or an ebook, or a service and a course. So you're gonna see a lot of different configurations, and all of those are open for you to use. All of those are fair game, and all of those can be successful. Okay,
so and everybody watching, I teased in the email two strategies I learned from Mariah that made a massive difference for us. This is one of them. So pay attention to this.
Ooh, which one is it? Wait, do I even know what it is?
The bundle.
Oh, the bundle. Oh yeah, no, the bundles are.
A lot of people, like very few people actually do that.
I know a lot. No one that I know of was doing this. And the thing is that it's great. It has, over time, we've had to refine our bundling sort of strategy, because when you start doing a ton of bundles, it gets crazy. But overall, when you're starting out, do this for 6 months and see how it goes. You will skyrocket your revenue and your community faster than anyone else by doing this. So the bundle was a launcher space and a blogging course from another woman. And the price range for them was $9.97. Now, the audience that came to this webinar, the audience that signed up is only 70 people. That's not really a lot, guys. That's not a lot of people to register for a webinar. 70 people, about 30 of those people showed up, 30 or 40. The bonuses that they had was office hours, and then the urgency was a 24-hour offer. So that's what they offered this for. Now, she made $15,000 with less than 70 people registered, okay? That's amazing. That's amazing. When was the last time that someone told you that you could make $15,000 in one day from having an email list of 70 people, right? So that's what's possible with webinars, because it's just a better way to make sales and a better way to make connections and really show people your expertise. Okay, so another case study we have is an ebook plus an ebook. Now this one was interesting because the price was so low. So it was 4 ebooks plus a bonus PDF. The price was only $30, right? That's really, really cheap. The urgency was that it was available for 24 hours. Now we made 200 sales. We had 400 people there, 200 people bought, and $6,000 in revenue from selling a little bundle of $30 worth of ebooks, okay? And here's my friend Melissa. She bundled some of her courses together and did a price point of $397. Her bonuses were 2 future live workshops. I love this idea. And I talk about this with my friends too, where it's like, it's awesome when you can say, oh, the bonus is going to be in the future, right? And then you can deliver the bonus as a live workshop in the future. So you don't actually have to make anything that day when you're stressed out about your first webinar, right? And I'm sure you've done that in the past, Brian.
Just did one yesterday. We fulfilled one that we promised a month ago yesterday. So yeah,
exactly.
That's a great one.
Yeah, we do that. We do that too. And it is very valuable, but it's good for you as the creator as well. So 24-hour offer, she made 70 sales and she made $28,000. This was like her second webinar ever. Okay. And you guys might know Jason Zook, my friend Jason. He did, he was selling his course, Buy My Future. I don't know if you guys ever heard that or saw that. He did $9.97. Now, the bonuses, there weren't really bonuses because it was like, well, you're getting everything. And he did 22-hour offer, made 22 sales and $22,000 in revenue in this one webinar, okay? So I just want to show you guys those other people with different types of products, different types of bundles. Some people are selling design. Some people are selling, you know, social media courses. Some people are just selling eBooks. I mean, it doesn't really matter, but just to see how other people are doing it. So how are you going to use webinars? Okay. Well, you're going to grow your email list. Okay. That's the number one thing. You're going to use it to establish your expertise before you launch your course or services. If you are thinking right now, I don't have a course to sell, I don't know if I should start doing webinars. Please, please, please start doing webinars as soon as you possibly can so that when you do have something to sell, people recognize you as the expert and they're excited to buy. Okay, so how people say, oh my gosh, I'm a nobody. How am I going to establish myself in this saturated market? Do webinars. Whether you have something to sell or not, that's the time to start. You could launch your first or next course with a series of webinars plus an email launch sequence, which Bryan and I both love talking about and writing and doing and all that type of stuff. You could also host an affiliate webinar for a commission. This is perfect if you have an audience but no products. This is something I've also done where I've just done a webinar where I did a training on a software product. And then I just had an affiliate link. This is like, I don't have a product. I don't really have anything. I just have a small audience. I just put my affiliate link in the buy now buttons. Like you guys see the buy now buttons on the page right now. I put my affiliate link there. And I was like, okay, well, here's a training on how to use the software. And then there's the button to buy it now that you feel more comfortable and you can see everything that it can do. I'm almost like pitching the software for something else. Have you ever thought about doing that, Bryan?
That's actually really smart. Like if you have a small list, you want to make money, don't even create the product. Just
affiliate. Exactly. Just do a training on like using Evernote Pro or like how to use lead pages or like how do you, whatever you're an affiliate. I mean, people, a lot of my customers are bloggers and they'll do like, you know, they have affiliate links for physical products and they'll just basically do like a QVC style, like look at this jacket, like look at my outfits, look at this thing, look how it works in the kitchen. And then they'll like have an affiliate link on the page and they make a shit ton of money doing it. So I think that that's a really smart way to start if you guys don't have a product and you're just kind of want to get started right away. That's a really good way to do it.
What list size would you recommend somebody waits till they get, if they're doing something like that where they're not teaming up with someone else in a JV type of offer, where would you recommend they wait to do or how big would you recommend their list being before they did one?
I mean, I would do it if your list was like 50 or 100 people.
Yeah.
Cause like if I made, I mean, if someone buys lead pages through me, I make like $300 per person. I mean, that's as much as I, it's recurring and that's as much as I'd make pitching my course. So if I had 50 people on my list, I would do that. And if I got 5 or 10 people to sign up through me, I mean, it's just, it's like really like, I would say don't wait is kind of my answer. Like maybe 50 or 100 people. That's like, that's, I mean, Bryan can show you how to do that in like a minute.
Yeah. Cool. So, I like it.
Yeah. So let's talk about the four phases of your webinar. This is the meaty part of exactly how you're going to make this webinar happen and then deliver it. Okay. So how you're going to actually pitch and make money and all that kind of stuff. The four phases are preparation, promotion, pitching, and post webinar. Okay. So phase one is preparation. You got to choose your topic. Now, my tip for you choosing your topic is to repurpose your most popular blog post. So just look in your analytics and just turn that same blog post into a webinar format. Or my tip for you is to use one module or one lesson from your course as your topic and what to teach. Okay. You don't have to create a new brand new thing from scratch. Just repurpose a good blog post that's already proven that people like, or just use something from your course because that's obviously going to lead naturally into your product. Now you have to name your webinar, okay? My tip for you is to name something that has numbers in it. I feel like the numbers or some sort of quantifiable thing, like you're gonna be able to do this in 5 days or you're gonna be able to do this in 10 days or something like that is really feels manageable for people. So maybe like how to do X in 5 steps or the 4-step process for doing Y, something that's just like, I'm gonna break it down step by step, right? Then you need to come up with 5 bullet points of what you're going to teach or the main takeaways that people will have. If you guys want to know how we do this, just look at the registration page that you signed up through today. So I want you guys to tell me in the chat, what is the working title of your webinar going to be? Okay, so with those tips, I'm like making you guys work today. With those tips I just gave you, tell me what your sort of working title is for your webinar, okay?
I love the plug and play template thing. Like go back two slides with the one that had how to X in 5 steps, 4 steps process for why. Like I was making some yesterday for a blog post I'm writing on naming products, and Nathan did a great job. Nathan Berry, in his book Authority, he had these like 10 templates for naming your product, and they were kind of Mad Lib style, like that, where you fill in the blank. I don't know if other people are like this, but with me, like when I have the idea for a webinar or a product or whatever I'm working on, like until I name it, man, there's like this big, this mental block. And I wrote down on my notes paper here, I'm taking as you go, those two samples, because we're trying to come up with a couple new webinars ourselves right now for some stuff we're doing. And I like those two. I like that a lot. So how to do blank, and like for us, it might be a 4-step or how to launch your product in 5 steps, or how to learn how to do yoga on a paddleboard in 5 steps. Like whatever your thing is, you can change up the variables, but those little plug and play templates help a lot.
Yeah. I love having those. And it's like a blueprint or like a framework or like those types of words. And we get a lot of good ideas. So how to hustle $15,000 like Bryan Harris in 14 days, how to build the badass body of your dreams in 90 days, how to
What's up, Jackson?
How to get your first 1,000 Instagram followers in 30 days. How to become I like that. 5 must-know tips for becoming a software product pro. So that would be perfect for what we just talked about, like becoming an Evernote pro or Lead Pages pro, whatever. 5 habits you need to lose weight, keep it off forever. All right, that's awesome. There's tons and tons of good ones. Megan Minz is saying, okay, I need all of these. So, in the preparation phase, guys, we're still in the prep phase. You're going to create 3 webinar pages. Now, these are the 3 main pages that you need to have a successful webinar. You need a registration page where people sign up for the webinar. You need a thank you page, and then you need the live page. Okay. And this is what those look like. Registration page where you sign up, thank you page where you get redirected afterwards. And then there's social sharing, which is really essential. And then the live page where you actually watch the webinar. And then there's call to action buttons, which convert way better than a system like, you know, go to webinar where you're just telling people to type in a link in their browser, which is the dumbest thing I've ever heard. Create your promo images. Okay. So make promotional images in sizes for each social platform. You guys know how Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook have different sizes for different, different optimal sizes. So make promo images that look the same, but they're in the different optimal sizes, like square, rectangle, you know, long, vertical, rectangle, whatever. Here's a really good example of a really successful and nice looking promotional image that my friend Sarah Morgan made for us. She's the best at making these, and then the internet copies her 5 minutes later. So I'm sure we'll see a bunch of these in the next couple days. But this is a really good way to kind of get people excited about it and see who they're going to meet and who they're going to learn from. Okay. Now, the promotion phase, you want to promote your email list. My tip for you is to write your emails just like sales pages, okay? People literally send out emails that are like, hi, I'm doing this free webinar, sign up here. Like, and it's like, no one cares that it's free. Like, it being free is not enough. I need you to tell me the benefits. I need you to tell me why it's worth my time. I need you to tell me how my life is going to change after. I mean, paint a picture of why I should be there and giving you an hour of my time. Okay, so please don't just send out a 2-sentence email that's like, I'm teaching my first free webinar. Here's the link. You gotta sell it. I mean, you gotta sell free stuff. Do you know, like, you probably know this, Bryan, you probably talk about this all the time. Like, you gotta sell the free stuff.
Absolutely. I mean, having a good reason. That's why in the webinar we did doing today, the one we did the last couple months, is always have a reason for them to show up. So, and it has to be true. You can't just make crap up. So like with you, I legitimately learned 2 specific things that made a massive difference in our last launch. So I led with that. Like, that's the thing you're going to get when you come. You're going to get a bunch of other stuff as well. I have a very tangible thing. Something that a lot of people do as well. I don't know if you do this, Mariah, but they have something free they give away when you subscribe to the webinar.
Yeah,
I haven't experimented with that, but I'm sure that would probably work as well. But just having a concrete thing with a story behind it, it attaches people deeper than just logically, oh yeah, I need to do webinars, I need to show up, but they're emotionally attached to the thing as well. It's just going to increase the number of people that show up and wind up buying your thing that you sell.
Yep. And then send out 2 to 3 reminders to register to your email list. I don't care if there's 5 people on your email list or 10 people or whatever. You guys need to promote it to your email list. That's where the promotion is going to start. Now you can create a relevant blog post with an opt-in for the webinar inside the blog post instead of a content upgrade. My tip is for you to optimize your site for your webinar with a custom welcome mat, what I call a cover page because I use Squarespace, and then use your announcement bar or create a pop-up just for the webinar. Now this is an example of what this looks like from our lovely Megan Mins, who you guys are all talking to in the chat. She used her front page of her website, this cover page, to promote her webinar, okay? And this is an upcoming webinar. So this is what people should see when they first land on your page. And it's only temporary, right? You're only gonna do that for a week while you're promoting it, but it's a really good way to start getting more people who are maybe just casually coming to your site and they've never opted in before to actually opt into your email list. Now on social media, like I said, you need to create images in the different sizes for each platform, and you need to tweet and post about it multiple times per day, okay? Do not just post about it once a week and be like, oh, no one signed up. You have to promote it multiple times every single day. Now, social media amplification is what happens on the thank you page, okay? So you're gonna use the thank you page feature to make your webinar go quote unquote viral. It's not actually gonna go viral and 100,000 people are gonna sign up, but people are gonna click that share button and they're gonna share it on Facebook, and then 10 new people are gonna sign up. And then from that, one of those people is gonna share it, and then those 10 people of those friends are gonna sign up, okay? So that's how that works. It's really, really important. Make sure that you write the pre-written tweet to make it really easy and increase those conversions. And now it's your big day and you're moving into pitching. So my tip is to give yourself plenty of time to get settled before your webinar, okay? I even do this now where I need like an hour of just like chill out time and just kind of arranging my desk and like getting all my stuff set up. That's what you need to do. Give yourself plenty of time so you're not stressed. Practice, practice, practice your presentation, okay? You might want to run through your presentation a couple times. And also just know it doesn't have to be perfect, guys. Like, I've had students email me and be like, okay, I did everything wrong, everything broke, and I still made $5,000. Like, it doesn't have to be perfect. People are like, I forgot what to say, like my slideshow died, like I couldn't keep, you know, I couldn't remember words. Like, people are just like, it was a disaster, and people still bought at the end. So it doesn't have to be perfect.
My entire computer crashed in the middle of it.
Oh my God.
Completely restart and log in. It was terrible. And we still did well. I mean, we'd have done better had I not just been missing for 5 minutes. But yeah, so stuff's just going to happen. You got to roll with it.
Yeah, guys, it doesn't, like, going into it thinking that it should be perfect is what's going to kill you. Don't worry about it. Seriously, don't. And then, okay, the beginning of your webinar, now we're getting into the pitching. So this is the day of, you're getting ready, you're actually giving your presentation. So my first tip for you is to tell your story, share your background, but only as it relates to the webinar topic, okay? Please make this short and sweet. This is not 20 minutes about you and your family. No gratuitous pictures of your family. Seriously, like, I do not want to see pictures of your kid and your dog. I'm sure that they're adorable, but that has nothing to do with what results I'm going to get by watching this webinar. And I think a lot of people mess this up. This is what I do differently than anyone else. Everyone else spends 25 minutes telling you about, you know, their background and their family, and it's just like nobody cares, okay? Educate your audience. Now, my tip for you is to assume that your audience isn't yet really sold on the idea of your topic in general. Like, in a very basic way, you have to assume that your audience knows nothing about what you're talking about, and they aren't really even convinced that they do need to know, right? So you guys saw how much time I spent just teaching you why it was worth it to even worry about webinars. Like, if some of you probably came here and thought, oh my gosh, I'm not gonna do a webinar, right? Hopefully by you guys seeing all the reasons that you should, I've educated you on getting into the idea of webinars in general. Now, that doesn't mean that I've sold you my product. That doesn't mean that I've convinced you to buy something. I've just gotten you familiar with that idea, right? Then you need to introduce them to the benefits of just learning about your topic in general. Okay, now it's time for you to provide real value. So my tip for you for the content, the teaching content part of your webinar, is to share your very best content that you have during the webinar. Here's the thing, you have 45 minutes to absolutely blow them away and stick in their minds as the expert and person to go to and person to buy from. you only have 45 minutes. You have to bring your best. Okay. You have to do your best content. Do not hold back. I always say this. If you're stingy with what you know, nobody will know how smart you are. Seriously. If you hold back on your content, people are just going to be like, oh, she didn't really know anything in depth. Right? Okay. Now it's time for you to transition into your pitch. My tip for you is to ask your audience questions to engage them. So by the end of a long webinar, people are like tired, and they just learned a lot and they're overwhelmed and their mind is, you know, worrying with ideas. You need to ask your audience some questions to engage them. You guys notice how I do that throughout this webinar. You guys are getting the most meta webinar training ever. Ask your audience a question and then remind them how much they've learned today. Actually recap the things that they've learned just for free. Now in the pitch, it's really important to show, don't tell. Okay, show, don't tell. My tip for you is that whatever it is you're selling, whether it's Skype calls with you or coaching or a course or product, make sure that you show it off as much as possible with visuals, even if it's digital products or services. This is an actual slide from a webinar that I did. And I said, look, this is everything you're getting. This was one of the pitch slides. And you actually get to see what is included, a tech training, you know, slides, a workbook, all this stuff. Same thing. I show the inside of my course site because I'm like, this is what it actually looks like when you walk in, when you log in, this is what you're going to see. Okay. So, and this is, again, this is another image that I used for a different webinar where I was like, look, this is everything you're getting, right? So you have to show, don't tell. The best pitch slides are mostly visuals of just what you're getting, not just like bullet points or text. Okay. Now, part of your pitch is urgency and bonuses. My tip for you is that your offer needs both a fast action bonus, which is only available during the live webinar, and a 24-hour offer. People need a reason to take action. They really, really do. Now it's time for your ultimate call to action and the purchase walkthrough. Okay, so this is the next step. My tip for you is to actually show your customers what they will see when they purchase and what the inside of the course looks like. So show them what it looks like when they purchase and they get their login and then they log in for the first time. You actually have to walk them through that with screenshots or actual video.
Yeah, and do you walk them through, like, do you actually log into the course, screen share and show it, or do you just have slides that kind of show them what to expect?
I do slides, yeah. But I know a lot of people that actually just go through the process and check out and then go into the course. I know a lot of people that do it that way, but those are the people who also use their sales pages as a pitch. Have you ever seen that?
What do you mean by that?
Well, like someone, like I think that the pitch slides are really important and right. I know that they are. Some people, now this is frustrating to me, but I've done webinars with people who maybe they were a little lazy and they were like, oh, well, I'll just switch my screen share over to showing my sales page because I already made a sales page, and they'll just scroll down and read the sales page.
Oh, that's terrible. Yeah.
As the pitch, but it doesn't work that way. Yeah. You don't actually need to show your sales page on a webinar, guys, because this webinar is the sales page, right? Got right. that? So I've seen, but those are, you know, that's what I mean. There's people who are more about like, oh, I'm walking you through the sales page. I'm reading it out loud. And then I'm going to go through the checkout process that way. I'm showing everything in slides. So I just think it's cleaner that way. It's kind of nicer. And then you just need to tell them to buy now. Guys, do not be that person whose voice suddenly becomes like 10 octaves higher when they go into the pitch, because everybody feels weird about that. like your customers are gonna feel weird if you make it weird, right? Don't make it weird. Like, isn't that a thing people say? Don't make it weird. So just use your normal voice and just tell people to buy now. You know, a lot of people tell me webinars seem like a really hard sales pitch. They seem like, you know, a really strong marketing. I don't know if that's for me. And I'm like, you know what? If you don't feel comfortable asking people to buy your product, that is an issue, not with the webinar and the way that you pitch. It's an issue that goes 10 steps back to your foundation where you don't feel very confident in your product, you know, in and of itself. So you just got to be able to say, here is my call to action. Buy now, grab it, buy it, enjoy it. Use it. You're going to love it. Okay. So like I said, guys, when you show people the checkout, this is again, another slide that I showed that I was like, this is what you're going to see when you actually go through, you know, this is what you're going to see when you actually click the buy now button, and then it's going to take you to the course site. So you also need to think about your offer. Think about the value that you're putting together for this offer. Now, like Bryan said, talking about bundles, not a lot of people do this, but I do because it works so well. A really popular bundle is a course plus a service that has some sort of done for you element. Maybe it's like, I'll teach you how to build your website. And then, you know, Caroline is going to actually write your about page for you, right? Because she's a copywriter, something like that. A course plus a bonus, course plus software. That is the holy grail of offers that I have done. That was my only $130,000 webinar was that bundle, but it's hard to pull off because you can't do that again and again. But it is very powerful to be able to say, here's the strategy and here's the software to do it, right? And then a course plus a course, of course, right? Sorry, I couldn't help it.
Dr. Seuss. Yeah.
So this is the final slide that you guys are going to see soon too, but this is the final slide. It's really important to show everything that your customers are getting. This is really important. Okay. Now this is another one I've done. They're kind of the same. It's just showing what's included, putting a testimonial and being like, buy now, use the button below, be really clear, super, super clear. So after your webinar, now these are the 12 critical hours after your live webinar. These can potentially triple your sales, and everyone I know screws this up. Everybody screws this up. Now, I've seen clients of mine and customers of mine have a webinar and be like, oh my God, no one bought. I made $0. And I'm like, okay, send out these three emails in this order. And then they made $25,000 just on the replay emails, made $0 live. Now, it's not ideal to make $0 live, but if you can turn that into $25,000 with an email, three emails following up after the webinar, it's worth it. So post-webinar emails are the replay link, the reminder email, and the last chance or urgency email. The replay email you send out immediately after the webinar. The call to action is to just watch the replay, and you just include social proof from the webinar. So this is just people saying, this webinar was so worth my time, you should watch it, or wow, this webinar was so good, I loved it. And then people say, okay, that's worth my time to watch this replay. The second email is a reminder email. This is sent out the next day, reminding them that the offer and the replay are coming down tonight. This explains in detail what the offer is, and it uses bullet points to be like, here's everything that's included. So it's a lot more pitchy. And then the last chance email is sent out just a couple hours before the offer ends. This is the final urgency email. You gotta explain how many people have already purchased. So sometimes I'll be like, look, 30 people have already bought, you should buy too. It's just a little bit of social proof. And then explain exactly what's included, the total value of everything versus the actual cost, and then a call to action, okay? This email sequence triples my sales every time, okay? If you don't do that, you're just leaving money on the table. So webinars are making money in four different ways. If you guys haven't kind of piece this together yet, this is what's happening, right? I call this the profit layer cake. First, you're making live webinar sales, right? Live on the webinar. Then you're making sales through the replay and the post-webinar emails. Then if you choose to, you can sell the recording, which I've done with success. And then you can set up the webinar as an automated webinar funnel, which is just going to bring in sales every single day because you already recorded that pitch and that information, and people can just opt in, sign up, watch it, get pitched, and buy, okay? So that can all happen in an automated way once you've done it live. So what tools do you need to be able to run this webinar? I have a really simple tech stack because I'm not techie and I just want to share with you what you actually need to make this happen. You need a decent microphone. I use the Blue Yeti mic. Using it right now. I got the HD webcam, the Logitech C920. If you guys want to write that down, that's the one that I use.
I think that's the one everybody in the world uses for the webinar. I don't think there is another one.
I don't know if there is.
I've looked around to try to find one. Like, that's like the only one.
It's the one. So the other thing I use, this is totally optional, but I have an extra monitor. It just makes it like, if you guys could see my setup right now, I have I have five windows open. I have the chat open. I have a separate Skype with my team. I have the live thing, I have the slide deck, like I have notes, I have lots of stuff going on. So I do have an extra monitor. This is what that looks like when you're kind of looking at it. You have your chat box, your video, you got your notes or anything, you have your slides on the laptop, your mic, your webcam, and you need headphones.
And if you don't have an extra monitor, like you can start with like an iPad and an iPhone, keep your, if you want your script out or some kind of outline, keep it on your iPad or something. It is good to have multiple screens. It's a little tough if you're working off a 13-inch laptop to kind of keep up with everything at one time.
A lot of people have just an iPad or just their phone for like the questions. Like they may have everything is like full screen on their laptop, so they're just looking at their phone for the chat and stuff like that.
Yeah,
I like that. So don't worry about that. Like I said, that's totally optional. That's like the next step. Now for the actual tech that I use, the software, we use Lead Pages. That's how we create all of these pages. Like I said, the registration, thank you, and live pages, that's what we're using right now. We use Google Hangouts on Air for the actual live stream. And then we use either Chatango or TLK.io, depending on the template that we're using, for the chat. Those are both free. So Hangouts on Air is free and Chatango is free. Lead Pages is $25 a month. But you can do it for free on your site. I'm going to show you how you can do it for totally free in just a second. I am going to breeze through this. You guys are such good sports. You guys are probably feel like your brains are melting a little bit, and I understand, but I do want to show you how all this stuff fits together into a launch of your course. So this is a little something extra. I do not actually teach this section, and every time I do this webinar, I do not teach this because it's a little more advanced, but I think that you guys are ready to see this because you guys are in Bryan's audience and he talks about launching a lot and he talks about putting this stuff together. So I think that you guys are going to be able to really understand, well, how does this all fit together? What does this overall strategy look like? So this is how to launch your course with webinars. This is exactly what I did. And I'm going to show you how you do it too. This is what I did in April of last year. April of last year, 30 days. We made $30,000 in the 30 days of pre-selling a course. Okay, so T minus 30 days from your launch. You want to start doing one webinar per week for your audience. Now, these can either be pitch-free, just pure value webinars that just grow your pre-launch list and grow your email list and just show your expertise. Like I said, before you go to launch, you want to make sure people know that you're trustworthy, right? Or you could do 4 pre-selling webinars up until your launch. Once a week, up until your launch, do free pre-selling webinars. That's what I did. So that's what I did, and that's how we did $30,000 in 30 days in pre-sales leading up to that launch of the first Femtrepreneur course.
Did you use the same thing every week in that, or did you have a different presentation?
No, we actually did a different presentation because we were joining up with other people. So those were incorporating joint venture webinars.
Gotcha.
So I would be like, oh yeah, let's talk about list building and Squarespace, you know, by setting up a landing page on Squarespace. Okay, let's talk about, you know, using Instagram to build your email list. So we would connect it to what the other person's specialty was too, because I was bringing it to their audience.
And the bundle thing comes into play with that. So you'd bundle the Instagram thing with your thing you're pre-selling.
Exactly.
That's super smart.
Yep. Why, thank you. So incorporate joint venture webinars to grow your audience and offer the special bundles. Okay. Just like we've been talking about these bundles, this is like how I literally took a course that did not exist. I did not have a product yet, guys. I just had an idea. I had a very basic kind of landing page, sales page kind of thingy. And then that's how we took that. And we actually took it to other audiences to like make sales, right? Like it's like I had a small audience, but I definitely wouldn't have been able to, I don't think, that well on this first launch because of teaming up with other people was how I was making that happen. Okay, so exactly what I did was I did 4 webinars in 30 days leading up to this course launch. I did 3 joint venture webinars and 1 was solo. Okay, so it took me 3 joint venture webinars to feel comfortable doing a solo one. That's not true for everybody, but for me, I was very, very anxious. Like I just could not imagine going live by myself. And so doing those 3 joint venture webinars kind of built my confidence to the point where I felt like I could do a solo webinar. And then I pre-sold my upcoming course at all of those saying, okay, it's going to come out in 30 days. And that's how we did that. Now your actual launch, that was the pre-selling. Now this is your actual launch is 10 days. What I want you to do during that 10 day period. And Bryan, do you do 5 days? I do 14. I don't know. Everyone has
open car for mine is 9.
Okay.
A Tuesday to a Thursday.
Whatever. Okay, so you could do 9, you could do 10, whatever you want to do. I want you to deliver one signature webinar multiple times, 2 to 4 times during the week of your launch. So you're just going to come up with one really perfect webinar. You're going to do this solo, and you're deliver it multiple times. So you want to give your audience flexible times so that they can sign up for it and they can actually come live and get the fast action bonuses. Okay, that's part of it, is just giving people multiple times they can sign up for. So are you guys ready to start doing your own webinars? I want to tell you what comes next. So here's the things that I really want you to do. Tell me in the chat too. I'm looking at you guys in the chat. I can see all of you. tell me if you guys are excited to do your webinar. And then we're going to get to all your questions too. So what's the next thing? You need to set up your webinar within the next 7 days. You need to declare when you're going to do that webinar and set it up in the next 7 days. This is absolutely essential. If you don't set that date and do this in the next 7 days, you're going to lose momentum. Again, I see this all the time. Lose momentum. You're going to come up with excuses, just like I did for 6 months. 6 months, I came up with excuses about why not to do this. That's the biggest mistake of my life. So you need to set this up within 7 days, okay? This is really important. I want you to write down your topic and webinar title. You can tweet them at me, at Mariah Coz. That's me. I want you guys to tell me. Write it down in the chat right now and then tweet at me. You got to choose a date and time for your webinar in the next 7 days. Then you're going to create your pages in Lead Pages, right? You're going to start promoting your webinar on social media. You're going to start outlining your content and then start working on your slides. Okay? So I want you to tell me in the chat, what is your goal for your first webinar? Tell me what your goal is for your first webinar. Now, I can hear a couple different kinds of goals. Maybe you want to tell me that you're going to make $1,000. Maybe you want to tell me that you're going to have 100 people sign up. Maybe you're going to tell me that you want to collaborate with someone that you've been nervously, you know, stalking them on social media for a while, if you're like me. Tell me what your goal is for your first webinar, okay? Because I'm going to hold you accountable to this. I am. So $2,000. Awesome. See, look at this. Twilla is saying that she came here, or he or she, I'm not sure, came here out of curiosity. Now you're totally ready to do a webinar. No idea what to do it on though.
That's I love okay. Your framework you gave as far as the subject matter, because I think that's something I've struggled with, especially when I was first trying to figure out how to do them last fall.
Yeah.
In a popular blog post you've written. And yeah. One hack, like if you're just starting, your list is small and you don't have a big repertoire of content, like go and look at other people in your space of what's been popular on their platforms and create a webinar based on those same subjects.
Just like that can work
really well for you. And you can find out what already has been validated to work with that audience.
That's a good idea. So just look on BuzzSumo for other popular blog posts and then see if you can talk about that subject. That's a really good idea. You want something that's proven.
250 signups and 50K of revenue. That's what I'm talking about.
Awesome. 150 subscribers, $3,000. Awesome.
My mom with her hypnosis business. I want to go to that webinar. Send me a link, Bryan@videofruit.com, so I can come to your hypnosis webinar. That's awesome. Gotta be awesome. I've never known anybody in that space. That sounds cool.
That's awesome. All right, guys. This is awesome to see all of your goals. So I'm not really sure why you guys came today, right? A lot of people are saying they just came because they were curious and now they've learned all about webinars, right? So maybe you came here because you're not really sure how to launch your product and actually bring in sales, especially something that you can do as a beginner, but you know that you want to create that like leverage income that gives you freedom the same way that Bryan talks about, the same way that I talk about with the digital products, right? You might be excited to create a webinar. Maybe you already knew about webinars when you came here, but you just weren't sure how to put all the pieces together, how to pitch, how to promote it, how to set up the tech stuff, when to send the emails, you know, what do I say, all that kind of stuff. Maybe you want to create these digital assets like we've been talking about, something that you can sell again and again or repurpose again and again to keep making profit. You want a simple, repeatable process for creating those ongoing, recurring evergreen sales of your courses, products, or even services. You want to build your email list, of course, right? In the simplest and fastest way possible, while also making new friends. Who doesn't want to make friends while they're working, right? We're building our businesses. It's terrible and stressful and hard. And it's really awesome now that I have people that I can actually talk to. And that's all because I just reached out to people to do webinars. So it's time for you guys to leverage your skills, knowledge and create value. Okay. We talked about how webinars create more value for your audience than anything else they've ever seen before. You also want to create the income and a revenue stream, right? All right. So you want to use a proven step-by-step system that takes you through building your email list, building your authority and your revenue with webinars, even if you have no experience. Okay. Even if you've never done this before. Now I want to remind you guys that nothing I shared today is like theory or an idea or something that I read somewhere else. I have used every single one of these strategies. I literally just laid out everything I do again and again to create this $1 million course business. Okay. So we don't have any advantages or special skills. I am really not tech savvy. I'm sure Megan will tell you this in the chat. She'll be like, oh geez, like don't let Mariah log into lead pages. we don't have any like secret tool or, you know, access to expensive resources. Like I said, I'm actually going to show you how you can get a bonus that just is totally how to do it for free. So you don't have to spend any money. You know, I still spend, no matter how much money I make in my business, I still spend $25 a month to just run this on lead pages. Okay. I'm never going to use GoToWebinar. I don't need to spend $500, nothing like that. I just have this system that works. Okay. If I can do this, I promise you, you can too. I'm really serious about that. I know a lot of people say that, but like, I'm like one of those like least likely to succeed types. I know that Bryan thinks, oh, Mariah, but you were so smart. And, you know, and it's like, yeah, I work really hard, but it's not like I was born like a tech genius or like I really knew what I was doing, right? I just figured it out by trial and error for a year. Okay. So how are you going to make money from your very own product and your audience? Well, we have put together the Webinar Rockstar and Rapid List Building Bundle for you guys today. Now, this is our step-by-step system that shows you exactly how to grow your list and sell or launch those products with webinars. Okay, so you're gonna get not only Webinar Rockstar and Rapid List Building, we have like 5 bonuses for you guys, so we'll go through all of those as well. But I really quickly want to introduce you to Gilit, who is one of my awesome students. She sent me an email the other day. She said, Mariah, I did my first webinar today, and even though the beginning was a total technical disaster, I made $2,000. I thought I was screwed and that it would all go to shit. I was expecting nothing. So thank you for being my total inspiration and for the coaching and the support. I can't believe that this is something I can actually do. This is the best of all my favorite worlds. I think the biggest thing is just her realizing, I can't believe I can actually make money selling these products that I've wanted to do this for years, right? Being able to actually do that. Now, Jenna said, Mariah is one of the savviest webinatrices I've ever met. That isn't a term it should be because she's dominating webinars. I brought in thousands of dollars on a Saturday afternoon. This girl's know what she is doing, listen and learn. And you guys met Jenna earlier. She made $15,000 on that webinar I showed you. She made $17,000 on her next webinar, and her next launch did $64,000 from just one webinar, okay? I'm gonna hand this over to you, Bryan, so you can tell us about what Michael said about rapid list building.
Yeah, so Michael tweeted this out. We did a little workshop last week and he bought, and give a little update, add on to this once I finish reading it. But he just bought it and was really pumped to take it. We did a live workshop and we'll talk about that a little bit here in a second. But he built his list of 50 subscribers in the first hour of being inside of the course. So that's, I think, awesome. It was really cool seeing some of the case studies that Mariah shared early on with people that launched with 70 subscribers, I think you said. Mm-hmm. They invited 70 people, had 35 show up and did, I think it was $10,000 or $15,000 in sales. Those numbers are literally insane.
Yeah.
And I think that's what's interesting and perhaps a missing piece of the puzzle of part of what I'm teaching on the monetizing your list side of things is being able to do it very quickly with a small list. So the rapid list building course will help you get to 500 subscribers and beyond in less than 30 days. Just with, if you're a nobody, know nobody, have zero relationships, and you're just bootstrapping it all. So Joseph, again, is a good friend of mine now. We met about 2 years ago. He's built his list to over 50,000 subscribers, did almost $1 million in sales last year by using the stuff we teach inside of the Rapid List Building course.
That's amazing. Oh my gosh. Yeah. His stuff is really cool. It's a really good example of creating a course that's technical training on a software and selling that for making your whole business out of that.
Yeah. Later on, Google just learned Scrivener Fast. That's his site. And he's really cool dude, really nice guy. And just, he's created a killer business just by building a list, doing a lot of webinars as well. That's been his main list building strategy.
JV webinars. I haven't talked to him in a while. I'll have to ask him about that.
Yeah. Y'all need to hook up. Y'all do very much similar stuff just in different worlds.
That's awesome. So what you guys are going to get, there's a lot of stuff, but this is just the beginning. You're going to get Webinar Rockstar, which is my course for creating, promoting, profiting from your own webinars. It includes 5 killer modules, video trainings on everything, comprehensive, clear tech trainings and video instructions. Now, we really pride ourselves on having the best, most like easy to follow tech instructions. And I have a lot of people in my niche who email me and they're like, hey, just so you know, I use your tech trainings. These are like technical people that are like, I use your tech trainings to set up all my webinars, and I show them to my team to set them up just the way you do. Now we have actual pitches in the pitch library. The pitch library is one of my favorite parts of this course. We just edit out pitches from different webinars from different people. We actually contact other people and say, hey, you know, your webinar did really well, or I've heard good things about your webinars. Can I just edit out your pitches and put them into a library so that everyone can study them? And it's really, really cool.
I bought your course about 6 months ago. I didn't know you had that. I'm gonna have to go in there and grab that.
Go to the pitch library. It's awesome. So you can actually see, you can study how other people are pitching and that are successful and study them, see how they do them differently than me, see how they're doing them, see what works. It's really cool. You also get workbooks, checklists, and calendars to keep you on track. So it actually tells you exactly what to do morning, noon, and night of every single day leading up to your webinar, promotion-wise, behind the scenes, what you should be doing, what your team should be doing, all that kind of stuff. You don't actually have to have a team, but I'm just saying it's like, this is everything that should be going on. You also get visuals and examples galore of everything. I don't just tell you what to do, I show you. That's one of my big sort of values, is just showing people what to do, not just talking about it. So you're gonna get masterclass lessons on everything from promoting to pitching, right? All those phases, the exact outline that I use to give insane value to my fans, but also sell the crap out of the products, right? You're giving value and making money at the same time. My own pitches and slides for you to study and use, case studies of all the real numbers so that you can see what actually works to help you launch with a bang, okay? So you're gonna create your profitable webinar topic, to create an outline of your webinar that engages, educates, and sells your product, create your actual live registration page, your marketing plan to get people to your webinar and onto your email list. There's a lot of little details that I couldn't go over today that are in this marketing plan that you must do, okay? You're gonna get a checklist and calendar for the week leading up to and the day of your webinar, and so much more, okay? This is what you guys are gonna create. This is basically what I wanted to show you, is like, what's gonna happen when you do that? Just this. Remember, you're going to get that hockey stick. Okay. We're all looking for the hockey stick. Now, what are you going to get in rapid list building? Tell us a little bit about this course. We have a couple slides sharing about rapid list building.
Yeah. So rapid list building, it's a step-by-step video course. It isn't one of those you have to wait for content to drip out or anything. You can go through it as fast as you want. So if you jump in today, you can be building your list an hour from now. There's actually 3 modules, 2 plus a little bonus module we throw in as well. That'll walk you through from picking your topic. I found, Mariah, I'd be curious to hear your thoughts with teaching a lot of people as well. Either somebody comes in and they're like, I know exactly what I want to teach, like stand-up paddleboarding for pregnant women.
Yeah.
And then somebody else is like my brother's like this. He's like, I have no idea. Like, yeah, I see you doing some cool stuff. Like, I think I could do the same thing, but I have no idea what the topic's going to be. So we'll give you a little exercise where you can pick your topic in 30 minutes or less. And specifically, we promise in the Rapid List Building course, if you don't get your first 100 subscribers in 7 days, you get a refund, we'll give you money back, and you get to keep the course. So we engineer the entire course around you getting rapid progress on your list. So we'll help you with picking the topic, help you with writing your first blog post, help with doing your first outreach, and specifically doing your first 100 subscribers. And then we have an entire workshop called the Monetize Your List Workshop that comes with it as well, that'll help you figure out what product to build, validate your list actually wants the product, launch the product. And the cool thing about doing this with Webinar Rockstar is that will help you launch it even faster than you could have otherwise. So that's a pretty cool little addition to it. And we'll walk you through all the technology. So just like Mariah does in Webinar Rockstars, there's a whole different technology stack you'll need for when you're building your email list. We make it super simple. 90% of the tools are completely free. There's a few options if you want to go faster, do something slightly more sophisticated. You can pay a little bit of money. Using lead pages is one of the tools we recommend as well to do that as well. But we'll walk you through what you need, how to do it, when to do it, the right sequence of doing those things to specifically get the result of getting 500 subscribers as fast as possible.
That is awesome. I love this course. So tell us a little bit about the specifics. Like you told me about the Eager Caesar technique. Yep. You're going to go through how to quickly triple the number of visitors who actually sign up for your email list. Yeah, and so also how to install these systems.
Yeah, one of the problems people have when they're first starting out building their list is like 90% of the list building strategies out there, including a lot of the stuff I write, are optimization techniques, like content upgrades. One of the best ways you can build your list, but if you don't have traffic, if you're brand new, it's kind of pointless to use it in the beginning. You're not going to see rapid growth in your list. So one of the techniques we teach inside of the course is the Eager Sneezer technique. And we've seen people, we had one person who really just killed it. She got 700 subscribers from scratch in 24 hours. More That's typical crazy. Is like 100 to 200 subscribers. So the Eager Sneezer technique is going to show you how to do that in a day. You can be past some of the examples that Mariah showed you earlier, people that were launching courses and pre-selling courses at 70 subscribers. You can be triple that in the next 24 hours just with this one technique. Tripling the number of visitors, like we do want to get you traffic. So all the optimization techniques actually work. We'll show you how to reach out and get your first 5,000 subscribers. And then the passive list building system, we want you to have a system eventually where you're not having to constantly go out and partner with people every single week and doing cold outreach and constantly doing that. So we want to set up your site. Just like Mariah said, she generates revenue and generates tons of new subscribers every day. And all that comes from a passive list building system. So we're going to show you how to set that up.
That's awesome. So by the end of this, you're going to have an email list of 500 to 1,000 subscribers. You're going to learn how to actually create an email launch for the monetize your list stuff, right?
Yep.
And then you're going to have a product to sell your list and a blueprint for moving forward. Now, someone in the chat just said that this is so good and it actually has like accountability built into it. So you actually stay on track. I think that's huge.
Yeah. So built into the course, like most courses you get and they're self-study, which means the completion rate is abysmal. The average completion rate of an online course is 2%. We found we're able to triple that completion rate just by having some basic accountability built back into it. So inside of the course, you get coaching from the team, you get coaching from the community. We almost require you to go into the community to share your goals and to share some negative consequences if you don't do the daily action items you agree to. And all that substantially improves the success of students inside of the course. So we did 2 weeks ago, we had a day, I flew the entire Videofruit team into town and we spent a day doing nothing but figuring out how can we help students, not how can we sell more copies of stuff, but how can we help more students who start, finish and get the result they're looking for. And we've engineered all of that findings and all of just from studying what other people are doing, like Mariah, people like Seth Godin, who's leading the way in a lot of this thought currently and stuff we've done, customers, the ones that have succeeded and the ones that haven't, trying to figure out what do the people that are making this stuff work, what are they doing that everybody else isn't doing? And we built all that stuff back into the course so you can get the same result.
That's awesome. So you guys are also going to get access to the private 24/7 live group chat. So for Revenue Rockstar, we actually have a Slack team where you guys have a huge advantage because you can actually find your joint venture web partners right in there. Now, we actually have channels for different industries. We have like a channel for health coaches, you know, channel for people in the fitness industry, a channel for people in like the copywriting industry. Like we just have channels for all different industries. You can always make a new channel if you're in a different industry. But we have people teaming up in there all the time and finding their joint venture partners. I know a lot of people are probably thinking, oh my gosh, how am I going to reach out to people? Now I teach you exactly how to reach out to people in Webinar Rockstar. I give you all those email scripts and everything to use. But this is just an easier way to get that in with people and basically have access to hundreds of other people who are all looking for other people to team up with too. So that's just built-in community, super easy. You're also going to get this bonus for behind the scenes of 4 successful webinars, okay? So this is, as you can see, actual stats and screenshots of how many people registered, how many people showed up live, how long did they stay, you know, how many people bought, how much did it cost? And then I go through a full kind of analysis of each webinar and say, this is what worked, this is what didn't work, this is what I think we could have done better. It's basically just me pulling back the curtain on these webinars and showing you all the data and really showing you what's happening kind of behind the scenes. Now, I told you guys that I was going to show you how to get a bonus that actually shows you how to do everything for free in your own website. So this is a bonus webinar training that I'm going to throw in today that is Badass on a Budget. And it basically shows you how to create your first webinar without spending any money on software. Okay, so it's just how to embed buttons and the chat and the Hangout on Air and how to do everything in your own website so that you don't actually need lead pages. If you want to do your first webinar, not spend a dollar, do your first webinar, make a couple $100 and then invest some of that money into lead pages, that's a great idea. So you're actually going to get this bonus course that we normally sell for $50 extra. You're just going to get it included today. You're also going to get the Monetize Your List workshop, which Bryan talked about, and the Quick Revenue System workshop, which I think you got to tell us a little bit about this because it's a super cool idea.
Yeah. So one thing that people really like, at least with my audience, we talk about building a list a lot. But nobody wakes up in the morning thinking, man, I want an email list. What people really want is the result of what that gives you, which is revenue, so that you can have more time to spend with your families. So you can have more money to maybe buy a house, or somebody was talking in the chat about buying a new minivan, or that you can have freedom to work on projects you want. So in the Quick Revenue System, it's a short workshop that'll show you 7 quick ways to monetize your list. So in the Rapid List Building course, we're going to show you how to get a couple hundred subscribers in 24 hours. And then the Quick Revenue System will show you how to instantly turn that into revenue for you. So I'm going to walk through 7 strategies we've used at Videofruit that coaching clients have used, that customers at 10K Subs and RLB have used, and show you exactly what they are, show you examples of each one and how each one of them works and how you can do the same thing.
That is awesome. And guys, we have a fast action bonus today, which is one of the best bonuses I have in my arsenal of bonuses. It is the Launch Your Signature Webinar, fill in the blank, done for you slide template. This is 60 slides, literally all the content, they're designed, the content is in there. It's literally like you fill in the blank. Like it's a webinar in a box, I would say. It's totally done for you. It gives you the slides, what you should say when, fill out this word, you know, put your name in here, put your product here. It's super easy to use. And people have told me that I should charge $2,000 for like this one thing. I've had people buy like $1,000 courses and be like, okay, I would have just bought it just for this. Like this is worth the cost of admission. So this is just gonna save you so much time and so much just thinking about things, crafting a good webinar slide deck, it can take me 2 to 3 weeks to craft a really good one, the signature one that I'm going to use again and again. This is just going to literally be it. You're going to do it in a couple hours. Okay. This is going to save you weeks, and it's all designed and all the content's in there. It's 60 slides that you can just be off to the races. So this is so worth it. This is if you purchase right now. Okay. So this is if you use those buttons right underneath the video and underneath the chat, this is what you're going to get. This is so, so worth it.
Now, that's huge, because putting together the webinar itself, like you can do it. And we were talking about earlier in the presentation of being able to put stuff together in a day or maybe give yourself a week. But if you want to do a really good job and like maybe design is something you get hung up on all the time, which I know is big for me and big for other folks as well.
Yeah.
Like having a slide deck already put together that you can just fill in your topic, fill in your words on it is huge. You don't have to worry about all the design and it looks decent and you can be proud of it. That's a big deal.
That is. I mean, this is like one of those things that's like you said, we could charge a lot of money for it. But what we do is give it away as fast action bonus that you guys can just be off to the races. Like I always reward action takers. So I want you guys to be able like, okay, I got my webinar slide deck done in an hour and now I'm ready to go. And like you said, the design stuff, that's not my forte. So it's really nice to be able to have something that already looks good. So are you guys ready to build your audience, build your email list, launch your product, and create evergreen recurring revenue? I know you guys are asking in the chat, what is the investment? So we put together this bundle today for $497. The value is over like $2,000. I'll show you guys everything that's included, a full breakdown. But we also have a payment plan, so you can pay in 2 payments of $250. Okay, so that's super affordable. Like I said, a lot of people make back their investment, you know, and then some doing their first webinar in 7 days. So you're definitely gonna, you know, if you do the work, actually do your webinar, pitch something, do an affiliate webinar, you know, pitch a service or coaching or something like that. I always tell people, if you don't have anything to sell and you do a webinar, people are gonna ask you to coach them and they're gonna ask you if they can hire you, whether you like it or not. And I've seen this again and again and again. People always act surprised and I'm like, I told you that would happen. They do a webinar, they have no pitch, they have nothing for sale, And then they get tons of emails from people afterwards being like, how much does it cost to work with you? I want to pay you to do this. I want to hire you. I want you to coach me. That's what's going to happen whether you like it or not. So that's why you just have to get started now. All right. So you guys use the buttons underneath to enroll now. Use the button that says get the limited time bundle now. Use that. It's underneath the video. Or you can use the button that's underneath the chat. Both of those are going to take you to the page where you can choose the checkout, or sorry, you can choose the full pay, or you can choose the payment plan. So you're going to see a page just like this, and you can check out with either PayPal or credit card, and you're going to be able to choose which payment plan you want to use. Okay, so just to go over everything you're getting Webinar Rockstar Deluxe, which is normally $497. You're getting Rapid List Building, which is $200 usually. You're getting all these webinar bonuses, okay? Everything we talked about, like the the quick revenue workshop, guys, you're getting that. You're getting the Badass on a Budget, which I normally sell separately. You're getting the case studies. You're getting access to the Slack. So you're getting the Mastermind access, which I normally charge $200 extra for. So normally people buy Webinar Rockstar and then they get upsold on joining the community for an extra $200. You guys are just going to get that built in, plus the fast action bonus if you purchase right now, while we're still on the webinar. If you guys purchase in the next like 15, 20 minutes, you're gonna get the signature webinar template. All right, guys, let's do this. Like I said, $497 or $250 in two payments over 2 months. Now, I know that you guys might have some questions or some hesitations, of course. Some people might be saying, I don't know where to start. Like, I've never done this before. That's totally fine. We assume, our kind of company philosophy is to assume no prior knowledge and take people really by the hand who are really just starting out. Basically, I think, well, Mariah a year ago didn't know what she was doing and she was really nervous and it held her back for a long time. What would little Mariah need? Basically, we're like, okay, let's imagine that everyone is Mariah and she has no idea and she's really overwhelmed. How can we break this down and make it so, so simple and so easy to follow? And that's what we do.
I'm totally going to call you Little Mariah now.
So Little Mariah. Oh, everyone calls me that. The tech stuff makes me nervous. Guys, the tech stuff made me nervous too. Turns out it's not super hard and we have really good tech training. So please do not let this stop you like it stopped me. I swear to God, do not let this stop you. This was one of those things that was like, I mean, it was terrifying. I don't know how to explain how I feel when I get anxious about technology. I get very upset, but this is not hard stuff. And when you have someone actually walking you through exactly what to do, so much easier. You might be thinking, I'm not an expert. Guess what? Like I said, that doesn't happen when you're sitting around thinking about how you're not an expert. That happens when you get on a webinar. So whether you feel like an expert now or not, people are going to see you as an expert the minute you get on a webinar and start talking about the topic that you're passionate about. You also might be saying, I'm starting from scratch. Like, I have no audience right now. Well, Bryan is going to help you get your first like 50 or 100 subscribers in like an hour. I mean, then you have enough people to have a $1,000 webinar or more.
Yeah. And one of the coolest things about your package, Mariah, I didn't realize you had this, was the Slack group that's broken down by industry that you can jump into, and you got, you know, 100+ people inside of there that are
we have like 800 people.
Yeah. So you can jump into any specific industry and you have people active in each one that you can team up with to do a JV launch with. So we had the case study in the very beginning of 70 people. You can get that in the next 24 hours. If you just start rapid list building 3 minutes from now, start doing your thing. By this time tomorrow, you can be past where that person was. Team up with someone inside of the Slack group that's inside of your industry and do a webinar this time next week. And you could triple the cost of what you paid for both of those things right now.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's the thing is like, if you guys are thinking, oh my gosh, who am I gonna tell about this webinar? Do rapid list building for the next 24 or 48 hours and then invite those people to a webinar in the next 2 days. That's what you got to do. That's
and you had the cool idea of doing an affiliate product on there. You don't even have to have a product. You just have a product that they're interested in, but you can sell someone else's product on the webinar. Like, you don't even have to have made your product yet.
Like, we would do like a ConvertKit one where we're like, oh, look, here's how to use ConvertKit. And then we just put our affiliate link in these buttons and we tell people, if you buy now, like there's no replay of this. And, you know, you won't be able to watch this training that we just did, but you will get this bonus training that walks you through how to use it for free if you buy through our link.
Yep. And you could do that like in the future, just like we were talking about earlier too. Like, you don't even have to have put that together yet. Schedule it a week out. in the next week, prep that, have the thing live, and now you have the product to sell.
There you go. Yeah, it's really, I mean, the other thing is that when you people say, but I don't have a product to sell. Well, after you do your first webinar, you do. Because now you have a really valuable training that you can sell again and again. I do that for a lot of my webinars that are really valuable. I sell them for $50 to $100 after the fact. And a lot of people might say, I don't have the time. So both of these courses, I think, and I think Bryan will agree, are engineered to get you results faster than like a course that's like, okay, we're going to go through this for 10 months or we're going to go through this for 90 days. Like, this should not take you 90 days. This is a, like I said, this is a 7-day or 14-day at the most process. It's just not, it just doesn't take that long. So if you spend an hour on it, you know, every day for 7 days, you're going to be good. Probably a lot less. So we are going to start the countdown timer, guys. This is for the fast action bonus, which you guys see here, examples from the webinar, your webinar slides template. Okay, which is the done for you, designed for you. Again, we have Keynote, PowerPoint, PDFs, like we have all different files. So don't worry about like what you use for your computer or whatever. We'll send you whatever, whichever one you use or you want, we'll send it to you in that file format. You're going to get Webinar Rockstar and you're going to get Rapid List Building. So Sarah says that Mariah's webinar strategies have helped me make $20,000 in just a few months. Her tutorials are super easy to follow. Again, we really pride ourselves on having these really easy to follow tutorials. So guys, I'm going to have this running in the background. I'm going to have this timer running in the background, but we are going to answer your questions. So the fast action bonus is only going to be available while we're answering your questions right now. Taking off my glasses because sometimes my nose gets sweaty and they slip down.
I ran out of water about 30 minutes ago. So my throat.
Oh my gosh.
I need to be like a pic. So power tip webinar, get a picture of water right beside your desk.
Oh my gosh, I totally have a picture of one.
So I have 2 pages of notes.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing.
So I got lots of questions for you as well.
Awesome. Okay, yeah, I'm excited to answer your questions. Excited to answer everyone's questions. Just keep, if anything came up for you guys, put it in the chat. We're going to let the fast action go, fast action bonus go until we're done answering the questions. I will probably skip back to the countdown just so that we can check in with it, or I'll tell you when it's ending. So, Bryan, do you want to ask your questions first or do you want to do the audience questions?
There was one that came in from the audience early on that I wrote down that maybe your team called as well, but it was from, well, I didn't write down his name, so I'm not sure what his name was. But he says, I have no email list, but I have a Facebook group of 9,000 fans. So how would you like walk through like the funnel you would walk him through? If you wanted to have a webinar by this time next week, what would Mariah do with 9,000 fans but no list?
That's really interesting. You know, I don't use Facebook myself, but what I would do is basically treat that Facebook, you know, that the Facebook group is your pool of people who are then going to register for the webinar. Can you put a pinned post with a graphic up at the top of your group since it's your group? Can you do a pinned post with a, like I said, with a link to the registration page? I would say every single day, go in there and remind people to sign up on the registration page. You're basically going to, if those people aren't on your email list yet, doing this webinar is the best way to get them on your email list. Look, I know it's hard to convince people to sign up for your email list with like a free ebook or like a checklist or like, I mean, everyone offers that and it's just kind of like not exciting to people anymore. Like you have to keep outdoing other people. If those people aren't on your list already, I would say that doing this webinar, you need to do that in order to actually get them on your email list so that they're not just living in this Facebook group, which you don't really control ultimately. So just go in there and just put the link in there, pin a post to the top with a graphic and the link to the registration page and just promote it in there.
Yeah, the big thing is you have the attention of 9,000 people, like invite them. And with Facebook, it can be funky because the algorithm stuff and you can only get 10% of the people to actually see it. So all 900 of those people might actually see it. You might even spend $50 like at the bottom of the little pinned post, you can just press boost this post and that'll make sure that everybody in the Facebook groups actually see it. Like it would be worth spending, if you have the budget, $50 just so your audience actually sees it. That's the downside to building your audience on somebody else's platform and not your email list, is that you might have to pay to even talk to the people that have already said they wanted to hear from you. And that's really annoying. So try to get those people over to your list when they register for the webinar. Like Mariah said, they're going to be on your list now. Now, next time you have one, you can just send them an email and 100% of the people are going to get it and see it, versus now only 5 or 10% of the people that you post a Facebook update to are going to see it. I like that. Somebody else said, I have zero subscribers, zero following, and nobody knows me. Like, they don't have relationships with folks. Mm-hmm. Like, what do I actually do? Like, how do I do this JV stuff? I don't have people. Like, walk us through, like, what that would practically look like for somebody.
So you're me last March, basically.
Like, my mom joined my course in November. She's talking about health and fitness. She don't even know what, like, a domain name is or WordPress that it exists. So absolute newbie. No tech experience, no nothing. Like, and she went through the 10K subs, or through, actually, she went through rapid list building first, and then I bumped her up to 10K subs.
That's nice.
And she has a list of 250 subscribers that she's emailing out from Gmail, BCC to all the people each week. Oh, so like, I finally got her to get on a freaking MailChimp account the other day. So she's finally like sending from a MailChimp account. But what should she do? Like, when I'm teaching like curriculum stuff, like I want to cover that use case. Because that's someone like, she doesn't know really like anybody else in the health world or people that have blogs or that kind of thing. So what would you do in that scenario?
So like I said, that's where I started. I didn't like have, I think it's easy to assume that like the people who you look up to or the people that who are successful, it's easy to be like try to find like their advantage, their unfair advantage. I wish that I had an unfair advantage because that would have mean I didn't have to work for, you know, 16-hour days for 12 months straight. But what you can do I want to tell you, and I want you guys to really understand this, you have more to offer someone with a bigger audience than just the size of your email list. The size of your email list for someone else who's bigger than you is like, they don't really care. Like, they don't really care if you have zero subscribers. That's not why they're gonna partner with you. The value that you have to bring to someone with a bigger audience who's gonna promote this joint venture webinar with you is that you have some information or a story or an experience to share with their audience. They're looking for content. They're looking to bring better content to their audience. They're looking for someone who can share a training or who can share some information or who can help them with something that they don't talk about. Like, I don't talk about Facebook at all. So I'm happy to have someone come in and talk to my audience about Facebook. I don't care if they have zero followers. I just made a plan with someone today who has zero people on her email list. And I'm like, oh my gosh, please let me promote a webinar with you because she talks about pitching to PR, which is something I'm interested in and I don't know about. She just started, but she has a great track record working in the corporate world doing this stuff. I'm like, let's do it. I don't care if you don't have any email subscribers. I just want you to bring your experience and your knowledge to my audience. That's the value that you have. So stop thinking that no one's gonna partner with you because you're just new, and just start thinking about the value you can bring. Now, the other value that you can bring is the tech knowledge. And this is what I brought when I had nothing to offer. I would literally say, if you say yes to this, to me asking you to do this joint venture webinar to your audience, I will set up everything on the back end. And now that was not the easiest thing for me to do at the time.
And then you go figure out how to do it.
I would figure it out. I would figure it out. And I would get people who are like, well, okay, if you're going to set, you know, they don't want to do anything extra. They're busy. You're already asking them for something. And I would say, you don't have to worry about it. I'll take care of everything. And I would take care of all the back end stuff. All they had to do was show up. All they had to do was email out a link and show up. You just make it frictionless. Just knowing how to set up a webinar is value in and of itself. Like, that's how I got like my first 10 joint venture webinar setups, was just by telling people, I will do the tech stuff. You don't have to worry about it and it won't be extra work for you.
So it's almost like it's almost like a guest post. Like, when if you think about like, there's a whole group of people that just teach guest posting and kind of specialize in that. Like, the way they teach that is, it's not about, like, if somebody was going to guest post on my site, I would care less what their platform was at all. What I really want to know is the content you're about to teach something that my audience actually wants, and does it fill a hole that we have? So like with you, you're saying the Facebook person, you don't teach about Facebook. If you bring somebody in that specializes in Facebook, just like we're doing, I don't talk about webinars. I'm not good at them. We've only done a handful of them. So let's bring in somebody that's really good at webinars and get them to teach that. It's completely irrelevant what size your platform is to that actual deal. What matters is, can you provide value? Can you provide teaching to their audience? And can you make it super simple for them? Like, can I just show up, give an intro, ask some questions and be done? If so, all the monetization of that is just on my platform. So you're borrowing their platform, just like on a guest post, when you use a guest post to grow your email list. Except the nice thing with a webinar versus guest posting is, you can develop one webinar, do it 100 times on 100 different people's lists. You never have to create new content for that. Like you can just have basically the same guest post over and over and over again.
Yes. Oh my God.
Versus having to write a brand new thing every time. And with a webinar versus a guest post, when I promoted this webinar, I emailed to my list twice, not to a piece of content, but to a landing page for Mariah's email list.
Yes.
Versus a guest post, when they email the email out once, maybe a lot of people don't even email out the guest post, and they're emailing out to a piece of content that then has some links buried inside of it to you. So just what would work better? Two emails dedicated to just sign up for Mariah's list for this specific purpose, or one email maybe dedicated to a blog post with some links buried inside of it that go back to your website. The webinar thing is going to convert. It's going to build your list significantly faster than pretty much anything else outside of like paid advertising or something, which will take you a lot longer to master and get good at. This is way quicker than almost any other list building technique. Do
I? Yeah, and this is all free, guys. I don't spend ads to get people to my webinars. I just team up with other people, or I go on social media and I get people to share it. So it's like you said, the ads thing is going to cost a lot of money, take a lot of time. Yep. This is something I just want you guys to remember, that there's two ways that you bring value that have nothing to do with who you are or how many email subscribers you have or how popular you are. Okay. You have the knowledge and the experience and the skills and the training that you can bring. And you have the ability, again, once you go through Webinar Rockstar, you're going to have the ability to set up the webinar and make it easy for them to say yes. Just make it frictionless. That's something Bryan and I talked about again and again and again when we're working together, is like, how can we make this so easy? We're going to write all the copy. I'm going to send them emails they can send out to their audience. I'm going to give them the links. I'm going to like set up all the follow-up emails, just make it easy for them. Okay. Okay. So let's see the conversion rate of, like you were just saying, versus like inside a blog post link versus like a landing page for a webinar, the conversion rate on the landing pages for the webinars are 80% for us. So that is obviously going to blow out of the water anything that you could get from like a content upgrade and a guest post.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's see. This is a good question. Someone asked about the conversion rates, and I've had this question before, and it's hard for me. I thought this is one of those things. I thought that 40% conversion rates on the regular was normal until other people started telling me that that was really, really high in the industry. I didn't know that I had the like highest conversion rates until lead pages told me, and they were like, you know, that's unreal, right? And I was like, oh, I thought that was normal. But you can totally on the regular expect like 10 to 20 as a base, in the same way that the math of an email list is that 1-2% is going to buy no matter what. That's the base for a webinar, is like 10 to 20. If you do a really great job and you really bring the heat, we're talking 30 to 40. So that's a really good question.
Registered or showed up? Like, what do you measure that off of?
I do it by who was watching live.
Gotcha.
So, but sometimes there's always weird cases. Like there was a case where 300 people showed up live, but then 350 people bought because there was like 500 people who registered and way more people bought than showed up live, which is very, like, you know, that's a really, it would be strange to say, oh, there's 150% conversion rate. So, but I usually do it by how many people were actually watching, who got the pitch.
And that's why that email follow-up is so important, because there's, three quarters of the people or half the people that registered for this webinar didn't show up live, but they'll get three emails after the fact with a replay and with a reminder of the bonus and then an expiration of the bonus. So they'll pick up more sales after the fact just by following up with folks.
Yeah. So someone said, Austin asked, I have an iPhone app that's going to be free that I'm launching soon. It's a social network. My question is, how could I get people to join the social network through webinar? If anything, I want not sales, but I want a large list of people to join my social network. That's really great, because that's what we were doing in the summer for List Goal and getting people to install List Goal on the webinar, right? Yep.
You just build it into the webinar, like that, getting people to install software. I think webinar is probably the easiest way to do that, because you build it into the webinar. Like you had three parts, the planning, the promotion, and I forget them now. I didn't write those down, but you had three parts of the teaching part. You would just say, hey, like we do in our webinar, the first thing you have to do is pick your list goal. Like you're going to have a million strategies to distract you. So let's pick your goal. Like, do you want 100 in the next 90 days? Like, and we give you some frameworks for that. And the next thing we do is, all right, go to listgoal.com right now and install this. And we walk you through screen share, walking through installing it. So, three quarters of the people that show up and watch the webinar, whether live or on the replay, install the app. and it works. So I would just get on whatever, I don't know what the social media platform is, but identify the pain that it's actually solving. Like, what's the pain it's solving? That's what your webinar is going to be about. Use the naming templates. I wrote down like six of them, two from Mariah and four more from the chat that you can name the webinar. Teach in that and make the very first thing you teach, go install this. Like, this is the first thing you need to do to fix this pain, and walk them through, to screen share and walk them through installing that thing. So I think with software, you're just crazy if you're not doing webinars. Maybe if you're doing like super high enterprise level stuff, but maybe even more so for that, your numbers are going to be different because your markets are smaller, but webinars are a great application for software too. I think that's I think it's very tempting to watch, like me and Mariah, both of us are in the marketing world. She teaches webinar, I teach list building, and to like silo in and say this stuff only works for people in that world, that is such complete bullcrap. It actually works worse for us because so many people are doing it.
It's
if
so
you go true. To software like email, like our friend Nathan Berry, who has ConvertKit, like very few email service providers are actually doing that and having educational webinars that teach people how to grow a list and nurture a list and use a list, and in the process, get them to sign up for their software. So if you can pull stuff from other industries that you see into your industry, usually it works better than the industry you pulled it from because other people aren't doing that. So
yeah, no, we have good at that. I mean, we have like, we're in a very cutthroat, and like people are like, you know, there's 100 webinars you could go to every day in our industry, and it's really hard, and it makes it harder for us. But when people tell me, they say, oh, no one in my industry does webinars. So, and they say that that's a reason that they can't do webinars. I'm like, you are sitting on a gold mine. I was like, please, please, like, don't waste another minute. You are sitting on a gold mine. If you truly don't think that a lot of people in your weird niche industry are doing webinars, that is so amazing. You're so lucky. I wish I was you. And when I do this in my other niche, which is the sort of sustainable architecture niche, again, no one in that niche is doing webinars. So everyone really, it really stands out, and it's just like going to put you head and shoulders above the rest really, really fast. And the same thing you were saying about getting software, integrating that into your webinar, the download and the signing up. I know that Teachable does that too, where part of their webinar is like, set up your school in 5 minutes. And then they're like, okay, this is how you actually like can set up your course in 5 minutes. And they make everyone, you know, you don't have to obviously, but they ask everyone to sign up for the free account and see what it's like to set up your school. Yeah. So it's really great to just work that right into the content. And obviously you've done that.
Experiment with it. Like, come up with an idea, start using it. It's way easier once you do your first one, just to keep on doing them and get better at that. Like, see, all right, well, that didn't work putting it here. Let me put it in the pre-launch piece. Let me put it in both places. Let me put it in pre and middle and the post-launch. Like, and just keep on playing around with how you're doing that. But it, like, webinars are just basic. There's nothing unicorn about webinar. What makes it work is just basic human psychology. Like, you have more of an emotional attachment, and do you look to Mariah more now than you did 2 hours ago? If you're still listening to this, 1000% yes. You've been listening to us talk for 2 hours. You know who we are. We've talked, we've answered questions, we've interacted with chat, versus if you just read one blog post. Like, for example, my favorite website right now is waitbutwhy.com. It's the best written content I've ever seen anywhere, and it's not even close. Like, the guy's absolutely amazing. He did a TED talk the other day, not one of those TEDx talks, but an actual TED talk. That the 15-minute TED talk where I got to see him for the first time, like, I probably have spent 10 hours at least, probably more than that, reading his blog post because they're so just mind-blowing. And it's nothing about marketing. It's just really cool topics. When I watched that 15-minute TED talk, my relationship with him, I've never met the guy. I've never even talked to him at all. My relationship with him went to another level because I saw him interacting in person. And with a webinar, you get to talk to people for 2 hours. Like, we're almost 2 hours on the dot now of talking to you. So the relationship with us is substantially better. We actually did some analysis after our last product launch of 10K subs in November. People that came to a webinar or workshop that we did 90 days previous to our launch were 3 to 5 times more likely to buy than someone that didn't. Because you just have human interaction with people. So if I meet you, we have a connection that we don't have if all you did is read my tweets and read a few blog posts disjointedly over time. So webinar just gives you, it's just an avenue to do that online, because it's hard to do that online because I can't meet 10,000 people in person, but I can have a webinar with 10,000 people or with 100 people or with 10 people. So that's why it works. That is true for humans. It's not true for niches. Like, it isn't true to just for knitting or just for paddleboarding or just for webinars or just for list building. It's true for everybody. So use that in your industry.
Yeah, I agree. And you know, someone's asking like, well, how do I get even that original list of 50 to 70 people? Like if that's as much as you would want to have like a good first webinar, rapid list building is going to help you do that. Like Bryan said, in like 24 hours or even less. So don't worry about like, well, I don't have that 50 people to invite yet. So that's actually going to be part of rapid list building. But the other thing is that what I've been able to do is just use social media and use the right hashtags and search for hashtags related to my webinar topic and then invite people. And I've actually made a lot of good friends by doing that. It sounds weird, but people are usually like, if someone's like asking a question about Squarespace and they're like, I don't know how to use this feature or hashtag Squarespace, and I'm doing a webinar about Squarespace, I'll say, oh wow, that's something we're gonna cover this Saturday. You should come, here's the link. And then I actually meet a lot of people by doing that. And that's a really great way to get started when you're first starting out and you don't have a lot of people to kind of pitch to. But the other thing is that you don't, you know, it's just kind of like the first thing I ever did, I think, to get email subscriber was a content upgrade. So that was like, you could do a content upgrade in a blog post that then leads to your webinar. So that would be kind of like the first way of kind of getting people onto that list, just those first 50 people even. Okay, have you compared no pitch webinar signups to content with a pitch?
Yeah, they converted the same.
Yeah, I don't notice any different.
Yep.
We already talked about how to build a list without Facebook ads. Is all about those joint venture, getting people to, you know, trading with people, bundling with people, work, just network hacking. That's what that is. Network hacking is just, well, that person has an audience of 1,000 people. I don't. How can I provide enough value that they can introduce me to those 1,000 people? That's how to do that. How do you approach people about a joint venture webinar? You just tell them the value that you can bring. Don't focus on the fact that you don't have a list. You just say, like, the exact script I use is like, hi, I think you're awesome. And I have this content about, you know, doing a webinar. And, or that's probably not a good example. I have this content about launching a course. Your audience, you teach social media. I think your audience would really be interested in this, or your audience is bloggers who are struggling to monetize their platform. I think they'd be really interested to learn about this. I'll handle all the tech stuff, so you don't have to worry about it. Let me know if it's something you're interested in. Let's see.
All right, I have a hard cut off in 5 minutes, so I can stay. You can keep going longer, but I gotta keep off in 5 minutes. So.
And the other thing, guys, too, is that in 5 minutes we'll stop the. I will actually stick around and answer your questions because I told you I would, and I'm happy to do that. But the fast action bonus will end then. So if you guys want to get the bundle, rapid list building, all the bonuses, and webinar rockstar, and start doing this stuff, start taking action like this afternoon or tonight, grab that now. And like I said, the fast action bonus, those webinar slides, I really want you guys to get those, mostly because they're just going to save you a lot of time and stress and, you know, someone else just putting everything together for you just saves a lot of time. I wish someone had done that for me back in the day. So please jump on that. Let's see. So someone just said, I did my first webinar last week with Mariah's course. Thank you. That's awesome. She loved the course. Thank you so much. Doing another on Sunday. What's the best way to promote? I would use social media like Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. That's how, once you get people signed up and then they can share it out to their friends, that's kind of how that spreads. So that's what I would do. Just like I said, using those hashtags and finding people on Twitter and inviting them.
And look at Mariah's thank you page. Like, go back to the thank you page where you register for this. There's share buttons on the thank you page. And I've seen some people do, we wrote a post on this. If you Google Videofruit Sumo Me, there's a post like last November. We're on the thank you page of the registration, they'll offer an additional thing if you share it. Like, it's a pretty cool little strategy. I'd like
to try that
on a webinar as well. Like, that could work well. I've even seen with Michael Hyatt, one thing he does when you register, they offer a prize. They were doing like an Apple TV or something. Now, you could pick something cheap. You could do time with you. You could do a product you have for one person that shared. So in the pre-populated tweet, they'd have a hashtag. They would search those, pick one person at random, and give the prize to them. There's a cool ways you can kind of hack the social media sharing piece. Because I know, like with me, like, I don't do a ton on social media, but reaching out to people via hashtag, or just go to search.twitter.com, search for the keywords surrounding your topic, and just start interacting with people one-on-one around your topic and invite them. Incentivize people once they opt in to share via making it simple, giving them a prize or giving them an extra bonus if they share as well. Those can be cool ways to kind of increase the virality or the number of people that see it.
Yeah. And it's like, this is what you do when you're trying to get 100 people to show up, right? Yep. Like, that's what I would do if I needed 100 people or 200 people to show up. Now, that's not what I do when I get 5,000. I've had 5,000 people register for a webinar before. That's not the same tactic I'm using there. That would be a different strategy, but that's the first way to start. If you're selling a course that's $1,500 or more, don't you think that someone might need more time to get approval for their boss or their spouse or someone like that? That's absolutely true. If you have a course that's $1,000 or more, you want to always offer a fast action bonus. Some people will be ready to buy, but do not feel discouraged if you don't get a lot of sales live. And I've seen this again and again where people are like, oh my God, I only made one sale live. And I'm like, how much was your course? And they'll say $1,500. And I'm like, okay, that's a price point where people need to maybe ask or talk to someone or get some, you know, they might need to move money around in their accounts. Who knows? Yeah. But that is something that those email follow-ups, which I give you all the copy, swipe copy, take everything, just copy and paste what I do. You can use my templates in Webinar Rockstar. Those follow-up emails then become where like 90% of your sales come from, right? All of a sudden, those are way more important for you to keep reminding people and seal the deal, okay?
Would you recommend like on a higher priced product having a longer follow-up sequence, or would you still keep it one day?
Yeah, I've done 48 hours for that price point. But
that's like a talk to your wife or husband thing. Like, exactly. You just don't impulse buy $1,500.
Exactly. But I also have students who are like, no, it's 24 hours. And that's what Jenna does. And she's, like I said, does anywhere from $17,000 to $64,000 on a webinar. And it's like, she's just like, no, that's the timeline. I've done 48 to 72 at the very longest, but I do think just inspiring people to take action is important. Like, it's the same thing Ramit says about, like, well, we only have like a 3-day launch because if someone's not going to decide in 3 days, I don't want them in my course. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying it's a thing of like, you just want people to actually choose and not just dilly dally.
Right.
If you have to run, that's totally fine.
I got to run. We went way longer than I thought, which is great. Yeah. I love the Q&A. Keep rocking. I actually have a guy coming over to the house. Like, he's been texting me. Like, I'm like, just stay put. So he's like walking around the house and fixing some crap. So anyways,
I'm going to keep going.
I'll chat with you a little later, Mariah. Thanks for hanging out, guys.
Bye.
Bye.
I'm going to hang out with you guys. So what we'll do is we'll let the fast action bonus go, those webinar slides. We'll just let those go for until I'm done answering your questions. When I log off, that's when those are going to end. So you probably have about 5 to 10 minutes to grab those if you guys want to grab those and jump on this. So I'm going to blaze through these questions with you guys. I'm glad that we just get to hang out, you know? Okay, so do you have to have a separate product for each joint venture webinar? No, not at all. Oh my gosh, that's a great question. And now I'm like, oh my gosh, did I infer that? But I use the same exact product every single week. Every single week, I'm pitching the same product. I'm just pitching it to a different audience, or I'm putting it in a different bundle with someone else. So if that person, so like last week, I bundled it with someone who had a blogging ebook, and that was the bundle. Or the week before, I bundled it with someone who had a branding course, bundled it with that. The week before that, bundled it with someone who had, what was another one we did recently? Oh, a visual marketing, like graphic design course. So it's different. It's me bringing the same product every single week, but in different ways. So, oh my gosh, you definitely do not need to come up with a new product every time. That would be crazy and exhausting. I don't want you to do that. How much do you spend promoting? $0. I've never spent a dollar on ads. You can read about it on my website where I talk about how I built a $1 million business with no ads, which I've never heard of anyone else doing. But it's not because I'm against ads. I just don't know how to use them. Sometimes I wish that I knew how to use them. But the joint ventures have just worked so well for me that it's like I would rather be introduced. How do you guys feel about this? I would rather be introduced. And tell me in the chat. I'm going to look at what you guys are saying in the chat. I would rather be introduced to you with a personal introduction like this, like Bryan introduced me to you guys. I would rather have that personal introduction from someone that you already know and trust versus just me showing up in your Facebook feed, like, click me. Like, do you guys feel like that too? Like, Like, I would like, how would you rather meet me? Me showing up in your feed being like, click my thing, do this thing, versus with no context and no, you don't know who I am? Or would you rather someone you already know and trust, Bryan, say, hey, I'm gonna introduce you to Mariah, who I've known for a year. And you know, we've been working together for a long time, and I'm gonna introduce you to her, and she's really smart. Like, what's the better way, right? To me, the ads are not how I want to show up to you guys. Does that make sense? Like, I don't want you to think, I don't want that to be how we meet. I want us to meet this way. I hope that that makes sense. And I think that, you know, I think that that is kind of my philosophy. So yeah. Okay. So let's see. I have a blog that I'm still working on. How complete should that be before I do a webinar? It doesn't matter if you have a blog. You don't need to have a blog. You can build your entire business and an email list. You need an email list platform like ConvertKit or MailChimp or whatever it is that you're going to use. We use ConvertKit, and you need webinars. You don't need to have a blog at all. If your blog's not set up, who cares? Who are you even going to blog to, right? You got to start doing those webinars to build up your email list. When you launch your blog and you post that first blog post, you're going to have a list of people that you can actually send it to. Okay. So that's really great. Don't worry about like, oh, I have to have three blog posts before I can do a webinar. That's backwards. All right. Let's see. How can I attract people to learn what they don't know they need to learn? That's part of setting up those, talking about the result that they're going to get. So no one knows what they want to learn. People just know a result they want to get. So when you talk about your webinar, you're like, this is what you're going to leave with. And you're not talking about the thing that you teach specifically. You're just talking about like, you're going to have more energy. Well, how am I going to have more energy? Well, I'm going to show you how to do diet and exercise or whatever, right? So no one cares about how they get there. They just care about the result. Is there a typical revenue split? Is it based on the price of each person's product, or is it just negotiated? So it's different for every time. If it's a straight up affiliate thing and there's no bundle, it's just an affiliate promotion, it's 30%. If it's two people putting in equal courses, equal value courses that are the same price or about the same, that's 50-50. But I've also done it where like I was putting in a $200 course and the other person was putting in like a $1,200 or $1,000 course, and we split it like 40-60. So I wouldn't get 50% for putting in $200 worth of value, right? Good question. Yes, right. So there is a split of profits just in the way that I just explained. Are there opportunities in being a webinar broker? Finding experts, working with them to create the webinar, and then promoting it for them. That sounds so cool. Like, you should promote yourself as that. I don't know like how that would work, but I feel like that's a really cool idea. You would find people who are good partners, use your own network, create, help them set it all up, and then do some promotion. That sounds like a really cool opportunity. I would definitely give it a try, right? That can't hurt. Okay, let's see. I know that Bryan is a ninja at pre-selling. How do you pre-sell at the end of your webinar, slide with potential modules, and do you send participants to a Gumroad page? Exactly. So what I did for those, you know how I explained those 30 days leading up to my course actually being available? I just had a link to a checkout page, which I use digital product delivery. You can use Gumroad. It's really up to you. But basically at the end, you're just explaining what's going to be included as best as you know. I mean, you don't want to like say that something is going to be included and then take it away. But as long as the only thing you're doing is adding more and fleshing it out more throughout those 30 days, that's totally fine. So our webinars would be like, here's the five things I'm going to cover in this course. It wasn't super detailed, but I had the outline of the course. So I was like, this is what's going to be included and what you're going to learn. And then as the 30 days went on, I would just announce that I was adding a new thing or an extra resource if things kind of fleshed out from there. Good question. And yes, just link directly to like a checkout page. You don't even need a sales page because your webinar is your sales page. Let's see. Does this course have suggestions on how to handle case studies and references section when you have neither? Great question. What I would do is talk, if you can, everyone can get testimonials usually from someone that they've previously worked with or someone that they've helped. Like, I had been helping people with their businesses for a long time before I ever launched Femtrepreneur. So when I did go to launch Femtrepreneur, I actually had people from like previous just like niches and other school, you know, things I had done that were like, oh yeah, you gave me great advice about that. I'm happy to write you a testimonial and talk about, you know, you as a general character. So it's more of a character reference at that point, but that's totally fine. I mean, when everyone launches, they don't have testimonials. It's never hurt. I don't think it's ever hurt me. If you sell a retainer service and discount the first month on a webinar, ideas on pricing that, I would have to know how, I don't know how much your retainer service costs in general. I don't know. Let's see. Okay. Awesome. Okay. Let's see. So many questions. You guys are so awesome. Oh my gosh. Someone offered to help me with ads. Thank you. That's so nice of you. That is so, so kind and generous of you. Thank you. Let's see. Just reading your guys' questions, see if there's anything that I missed or if there's anything I should check out. I really appreciate you guys staying on this long. I know it's just as nice for me to see that you guys are engaged and excited about this. I just really appreciate it. I really appreciate your guys' time today. You guys are troopers for staying this long. thank you so much. Oh my gosh. Okay, so your retainer is $500 a month. Yeah, I would do $400 for the first month. I mean, service work is different than selling courses. Like, I can do a discount on a course, and it's not like I'm taking a hit on like hours worked. Thank you. I appreciate you guys. But with services, it's harder, right? Because you're like working for those hours. So I would do like $350 to $400 as the discount price at the most. Because you can't, you know, you need to be able to make what you're worth. It's a great way to get people in the door, though, for sure. Such good questions. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much. I am going to hop off. I appreciate you guys coming. I am happy to answer your questions on Twitter. Like I said, I'm always, you know, answering questions there and helping people out. And give me your suggestions or your questions, your ideas about your topic, your title, your bullet points. Just hit me up on Twitter. Let's see. And I know you guys are probably, you know, I see questions about like services, different niches. It's all the same principles. It's just framing it in a way of like, how can I put this in a different niche? So a lot of people say, well, how am I going to do this for a physical product? If you guys have ever seen QVC, you've seen how the idea of a webinar can work with a physical product. I have people in my course who are like yoga teachers, you know, they do yoga things. I have people in my course who are like cooks. So they're like gonna sell a recipe book at the end and they're gonna show you how to bake a pie live in their kitchen with a webcam for their webinar. I mean, it works for everything. And it's just really awesome and fun way to connect with your customers and like provide value and get to know them. And it works for physical stuff. It works for services, especially if someone's going to hire you to actually do services for them, whether it's as a coach, a consultant, a copywriter, a designer, they want to know that they're going to vibe with you. The best way to figure that out in like 5 seconds flat is to do a video like this. So you're going to get people that are like, okay, I like the way that she talks. I like the way that she explains herself. You know, she seems really professional. I'm going to contact her about designing my website, versus just looking at your web, you know, looking at your portfolio and being like, I don't really know if I would like working with this person for 6 months. Right. So this is the best way to sell services as well. Thank you guys so much. When is my next webinar? You guys will be invited. So just as Bryan explained, when you guys came to this webinar, you got introduced to me. You guys will be invited to my next webinar. So I will tell you when it is and what it's all about. I don't know off the top of my head what our next one is, but I think it might be a ConvertKit webinar where Nathan Barry and I talk about all sorts of fun stuff, which is always really good because Nathan and I have a lot of fun. Thank you guys so much for coming. Thank you guys for joining. I will just say that we'll do the fast action bonus for another, you know, when I log off, we'll do it for like a minute. Like we usually let you guys, I know sometimes people are trying to purchase and it's like not going through. So as long as you guys buy in the next like 2 to 3 minutes, like while I'm logging off, you'll get everything, all the bonuses, all the webinar bonuses and the fast action bonus. So you guys are awesome. Thank you so much. Oh my gosh. Thank you so much. Keep on rocking. This was a huge help. You're so welcome. Thank you. I don't know if I can answer this exactly for Bryan. Rapid list building though is like, you know, how to get your first 500 subscribers. Whereas 10K subs is 10,000 subscribers. So that's kind of the level of information. Rapid list building is like, get started, get that first 500 to 1,000 subscribers. And then in order to get 10,000, he teaches a lot of other stuff in 10K subs. That's my idea about that. That's what I know. Don't want to totally speak for him though. So awesome. Yes. Let's see. That would be awesome. I would love to hear from you guys. So yeah, definitely. If there's any issue paying with PayPal, the PayPal works for the full payment, but you need the credit card to work with the payment plan. That is something that is just like the way that the system works is that it'll do the payment plans with credit cards and then we'll do full or PayPal for, you know, if you want to use PayPal, you got to do the full pay. If you want to do the payment plans, you can do either full pay or, I mean, sorry, you got to use credit card. That probably made it more confusing than it had to be. okay. You guys are awesome. Thank you so, so much. Have an amazing evening. And for everyone that joined us, which there are many, oh my gosh, welcome everyone. Welcome RB, welcome Raphael, welcome Renee, welcome Claire, welcome Dan, welcome Nicole, welcome Joe, welcome Abigail. Oh my gosh, welcome everybody into the course. I can't wait for you guys to get started really, really soon. All right. I will talk to you guys later. Thank you so much for hanging out. Can't wait to see you guys at the next webinar. Bye.